Gary Yuke, a YouTube channel with more than 500 videos, a lot of uncomfortable jokes, and gaming content for everyone to enjoy. Over the past 5 years, I had one goal in mind, reach 1000 subscribers and gain access to monetization. But many of you might wonder, what made me start my YouTube channel and how did I build up my YouTube channel? Today we're going to look back what happened in these years. Going from a crappy YouTuber that uploads random videos to a YouTuber that uploads high resolution videos in 60fps, there's a lot more behind it than you expect. So that's why I'm here to tell you the story of my channel. This is GamerYuke's channel history, the journey to 1000 subscribers. The year is 2012, and the month is November. At a very cold day, I was sitting in my home to watch some YouTube videos. There was only one thing I wanted that day. How do I like videos and how do I comment on videos? I've been wanting to do that on videos for years, and I couldn't find a specific way to do it. Until I saw you had to make a YouTube account in order to have access to it. When I found out, nothing was able to stop me from making my account. I wrote down my email address and password, and there you go. GamerYuke was born. But just to like and comment on videos, I didn't do anything else with it, but that will all change a few years later. ...2015 went by and the year was 2016. My YouTube channel was 3 years old and there was still no signs of videos found on my channel. Whatever, school was starting again and that was the last thing I wanted. All I cared about was playing some games with friends. What made school worse around that time was that I had a classmate that was dealing with a depression around that time. To keep a long story short, he was insane. So insane that he was banned from my school. I did respect that, but I straight up felt bad for the guy. But moving on. I had some friends to either play games with or just to talk with them. When playing games, I always brought either my Nintendo 3DS to play Mario games or my PC to play a certain Flash game that got me into YouTube. But we'll talk about that later. The Flash game we played was called Everybody Edits, a 2D fight Minecraft x Mario game where you can create and play in other worlds that you and other people make. About the same idea that Super Mario Maker has. It wasn't really popular, but it was incredibly fun to play. A day in March, I decided to make a world about a huge race. It took me several weeks to make, but it was a race that in my life I will never forget anymore. This is the creation that made me start YouTube. When the race was completed, I asked my friends to try it out. And that's where one of my friends came up with, "Can I record this race and upload it to my YouTube channel?" And of course I approved. Okay. When he did, he uploaded this video to the channel and asked me to subscribe to his channel. Which of course I did. When I saw the video, that was the moment I realized I wanted to start my own YouTube career as well. You remember the quote I said in the Q&A video that was uploaded a few months ago? I said this. They've told me that I also should make a channel and make videos on it. Who knows, maybe I could be really popular. Yes, they did. And now I was fully aware that I wanted to start my YouTube channel. After a small discussion with my parents, they allowed me to make my channel under a few conditions. Never show your face and never share any other privacy related stuff about you. We will be watching you. And that's where it all started. It was about time to finally get the recording software for my videos. Back then, I had no idea where to begin. All I needed was a little help from my friends that own the channel as well. I had some suggestions, but all the suggestions I've gotten were from cameras that cost money, which of course I will never pay for. All I needed was a camera that is working fine, is easy to use, and is free. Then I got introduced to OBS. Someone told me that OBS is working incredibly well with recording and is definitely a must-have for me if I want to start my channel. So I decided to go with OBS. When I was back home, I decided to make my first video of Everybody Edits to show my world a little bit. Since I really, really sucked in English back in 2016, I decided to keep my content in Dutch language. I just wanted to test if OBS really worked. When I was done, I immediately uploaded it to YouTube to see the result. No way. You have gotten to be kidding me. A black screen is all I get? Meh, maybe it wasn't there on OBS. So I tried to record it again. I did about the same things on my video, show my role that everybody edits, and upload the video. And yet, after one more attempt, I still got a black screen. At this point, I was starting to wonder if something was wrong with my OBS. I gave it one more go. And you guessed it? And yet, after all these attempts, I still got a black screen. I decided to give up my hope on OBS Studio and ask my friends again if they had other suggestions. And this is when my boy Mike9090 jumped in to get to the rescue. Back in 2016, he also published some videos on YouTube here and there. Mike introduced me to MediaCore Capture HD, basically a camera you can download from the Google App Store. It was far less professional than OBS, but it was definitely worth a try to test out if it really worked. So I remade the video and hope for the best. The video was completed and everything I hoped for was to finally get rid of that black screen that got me on OBS. I uploaded the video to YouTube and I've finally done it. The black screen is no more. But what even is the frame rate of the video? I honestly didn't even care about the frame rate of the video. All I cared about was that it worked out and that I finally got rid of the irritating black screen. I, however, got a tip from one commenter. He stated, "It's a good video, but please turn on your mic in the next video." This was going to be a problem. How am I supposed to turn on my mic if I don't have one? I saved the tip for later and focused on making more content. Since I was in love with making everybody edit videos, I will call it EE for short, I decided to go on with it. I made a pixel art video, a belt battle video, and I even celebrated my 10 subscribers milestone in Everybody Edits. It was a crazy experience. Oh, talking about subscribers by the way, I was a really greedy boy back in 2016. I basically asked everyone I saw to subscribe to my channel, which was the reason why I got to 10 subscribers that quick. Yeah, there wasn't a better way I could find to gain subscribers. Anyways, going back to the story, my 10 subscriber special was done and I started to play other Flash games. One of them was called Super Mario 63. It was by a landscape the most insane Mario Flash game I have seen on the internet. But what I didn't know was that I played on a very unfinished version of the game and I stumbled into many glitches and bugs. Unfortunately, I can't show them anymore since, well, it's a Flash game and Flash got removed from Chrome. But there was this one specific glitch I recorded and uploaded to YouTube. Something I still find funny about the video to this day is that I literally used Google Translate to translate everything I typed in the video, so people from other countries could understand what I'm saying. It was such a weird idea, but it worked, I guess. After a few more SM63 videos, I decided to go back to EE. I uploaded a few more videos of playing roles from other players, like Curse Mod, some sort of Mario Kart role, which was actually incredibly fun. Like seriously, playing someone else's role and recording to YouTube was the best thing I could ever ask for. After the Mario Kart video, I decided to make my own Everybody Edit series called Player Created Races, where everyone who was talented in making races creates their own race, as long as they didn't troll. I made some races on my own as well, but I didn't even came close to a creation someone else made. It was absolutely incredible how creative and talented all the other players were in making their races, and I would love to bring the series back at some point, but again, Flash died, so EE died as well. So there's no chance this will ever happen again. I made a total of 5 episodes of the series, but due to getting so few views, I decided to stop and go on with something else. And then there's this video. I don't know what the idea behind this video was, but I think I was like, you know what, let's make a video and end it in like 30 seconds. I guess in some circumstances, I tried to remake Random Video 1 to kind of introduce myself. But I digress. After the race series, I was dealing with a stomach flu that didn't shut the pineapple for 2 weeks. Like, seriously. I was having a hard time throughout this whole period. I lost 8 kilograms in a period of 2 weeks. And I was straight up not in the mood of making videos at all. When I felt better, the first thing I did was going back to making videos, because I just hit the 25 subscribers milestone. So I decided to bring it back where it all began. Making a huge race and play on it. It was the biggest video I've ever made to that day. It was almost 2 hours long. Unfortunately, the recording software I was using decided to not work anymore at a certain point, which was kind of disappointing, but also kind of understandable, since like I said before, the recording software I was using was far less professional than OBS, and I also had a really weak PC. Around the time, I was also thinking of getting a new recording software, because I didn't really like being stuck at 2 FPS. After browsing on the internet for a while, I finally found a replacement. Browsing a bit on the internet, and I found a recording software by the name of S-Recorder. At first I was kind of wondering if this software would fix the FPS of my video, but after trying it out on the Happy Wheels video, it seems like it worked like intended. A great resolution, and finally 30 FPS instead of only 2. However, it still didn't record audio. This made me kind of disappointing. Everything works great, except the audio. I then had an idea to turn on my mic in the software to see if that would eventually fix my biggest problem at the time. Well, it sorta did. You heard the game audio, but also my voice. For safety reasons, I unlisted the video so nobody could see it. I just didn't want to reveal my voice yet at the time, because I was just a beginning YouTuber and I wanted to take my time to slowly improve my content. A voice reveal was still out of the window, so thanks to that one slight problem, S-Recorder was removed from my PC, and my search for a new camera continued. I remember that I tried Bandicam for once. It was a great camera and it was almost my replacement, but there was one fatal flaw. Unless you have premium, the maximum recording time was 10 minutes. That did really hit me, because the camera overall was great, but once again, my journey of looking for a new camera continued, again. And then I found it, a camera by the name of a PowerSoft Free Screen Recorder. Now, the name sounds like it belongs to a trash can, but it was actually a pretty solid software. So once again, I tried to record a video, and I immediately saw that this is going to be my main camera for that time. Right at the start of the recording, it lets you decide if you want to record desktop audio, which was my main key to record videos. After making my video and uploading it to YouTube, I've made my decision. This is going to be my recording software. This meant only one thing. I had access to record many other games from that point. I've made more Happy Wheels videos, more SM63 videos, more EE videos, and also some big races like the race I've made for my 25 subscribers special, and even some different kind of videos, like searching up a random website that was foreshadowing upcoming Nintendo games. At least, that's what I thought. It were just websites that predicted upcoming games. Seeing Nintendo making games like that would be a dream come true. Yet, it didn't happen. Such a shame. Also, something I tried on was to make a custom track. I am not kidding. A 14-year-old boy that has no knowledge about programming tried to make a custom track. That wouldn't go well, would it? As I expected. Please just don't add this to CTGP. Not even I would enjoy it. And then there's this animation. Do I have anything to say about this? Then it was time to take on my next EE project. Again about races. This time I spent an entire day to create all the Rainbow Road tracks from the Mario Kart series. But how did it inspire me to make this road though? Well, it was from this world I recorded a while back. That will truly show me that making stuff in events like that can have some huge influence to your world so a lot of players can play it. The video was quite decent, even to this day, but I can improve it by adding music to it. Unfortunately, because I was going on a vacation the day after, I had no time left anymore to remake the video. So I did it after my vacation, which was 2 weeks later. I'm honestly really happy that I remade this video, because it really stood out from my other videos. Because this was my first video where I ever used music. It was a great change. It wasn't taking long until my next video. One day, someone came to my world and told me he had a bot that can make a creation within a matter of minutes. Luckily, I was able to record it, because what he did was absolutely incredible. Not gonna lie, I was stunned when I saw what a bot could do. Within a good 5 minutes, the bot completed a creation that a normal human can't even make within a year. So I decided to play on it for a bit to show what the bot has made, and I uploaded it to YouTube. And starting from this video, I got introduced to the copyright system. See, back in 2016, Nintendo was still actively claiming creators' content for using the music in the videos. But since I had no idea what was going on, I thought my channel would be removed if they used the music. So I removed the video immediately to replace the music. I got claimed a few more times, but I would go till the claim was gone. I did download the bot for myself to test out what it could do, and also made some videos out of it. It was quite game-changing, and I had a ton of fun with making the videos, but then that one day in August, something huge happened. It was August 22, 2016, and a new type of video was uploaded to my channel. It wasn't about EE, it wasn't about SM63, it wasn't about any other Flash game or PC related stuff. No, it was a video of Mario Kart Wii that popped up out of nowhere. Was I finally able to do a voice reveal? No, I wasn't. It was just a video of me showing a run I had on Grumble Volcano, but the video was a huge mystery. While the footage looks generally awful to look at right now, this was about the biggest change I've ever made on the channel, even to this very day, but I wasn't done yet. I also showed a run of Mushroom Gorge. The video is currently being removed, so there's no way you guys could see it, unfortunately. But then, a day later on August 23, 2016, something even bigger happened. Right at the very first second of the video, you heard this.
Hoi, YouTube fans en vrienden.
And just like that, my voice was finally revealed. I was so happy to finally reveal how it sounds. It was a dream come true, but once again, the video footage was kinda horrible to look at. I was using a pretty horrible camera that wasn't really meant for recording your games. I used Ucam, basically a camera that was meant for making funny faces. I however used it for recording my games. What kind of sense does that make? Whatever, I guess most of you watched the video because you wanted to hear my voice. Even though you said that, I still appreciate you. Moving on to the comment section of the video, and a lot of people were surprised that I have made this. I have seen many positive comments in it, like this one. Great video. It's good to see you're finally using sound in your mic. And also this comment. You sound like you're 24 years old, but finally, a voice reveal. That comment cracked me up. Did I really sound like someone that was 24 years old? I don't know if this was something good or something bad, but I still found it funny. These new types of videos were incredibly fun to make, so I decided to make more of it. Of course, I did remove some of the videos because they were getting old, but I also made a new Super Mario Bros. Wii coin glitch video. Of course, it was kind of obvious the glitch was there, but I really wanted to also have some variation in my content. Around this time, I also tried to record Mario Kart 7. Yeah, that didn't go well. Take a look.
Hallo YouTube, sorry, ik heb echt een hele stomme manier om een Nintendo te gaan filmen. Ja, sorry, ik zit nu achter mijn laptop en daarmee zit ik mijn Nintendo te filmen om niet mezelf te laten zien, dat mag ook niet.
Yeah, no, that didn't really work. Still a funny way to record your videos if you don't have a capture card though, but it still doesn't work. Most of the video isn't showing my gameplay, it is showing a bit, I guess. Still a nice try though. After making some videos via Ucam and some more videos on VE and any other Flash game I played around that time, I have reached my first view milestone, 1,000 views. My first idea was to livestream for 2 hours to do a full Grand Prix of 32 races of a fan-made project of Mario Kart Wii. The project was called Mario Kart Wii 2. Basically, a mod that has some of the oldest custom tracks in the history of Mario Kart Wii. But due to running into issues, live streaming was out of the window, so I decided to record it. It's still 2 hours long and could still be enjoyable to watch. When I was done with the video, I went back to making more videos. Throughout this time, I made videos of many games. For example, Mario Kart Wii, New Super Mario Bros. Wii, Wii Sports, Wii Party, Mario Party 9, Super Mario Galaxy 2, and I also focus on Flash games here and there. But my main focus was Mario games. It was such an enjoyable and memorial experience. Also something I wanted to make was a Let's Play of Super Mario 63. The game was really enjoyable, but the Let's Play was removed because it literally has like 0 views. However, I still saved some clips in the compilation we will talk about later. It was just some glitches and funny moments, but at least you can see a bit where I was going to when doing this Let's Play. I also tried to make some tutorials on how to make a thumbnail or how to make a video, but those videos were kind of forgettable. At a certain point, I reached 40 subs, and you guessed it, I was back to make yet another special video. It was about Everybody Edits, where I said in my vault to ask people to subscribe to my channel. pretty obnoxious idea if you ask me, but hey, it is somewhat different from the other videos. Because I found the video kind of bland, I decided to make a second special video as well, this time about the part 2 of my pixel art on EE again. A quite improvement over the first pixel art video, mainly because I used music and more sound effects, but my main priority at the time was to still make videos via YouCam. But after doing this for 2 months, YouCam was starting to have issues. I wonder what caused it, so I went to a computer shop to eventually look into the problem. My PC arrived at the shop and all I did was waiting patiently to get it back to go on with making videos. In the meanwhile I realized I still had my really old PC with me. Should come in handy to make videos on it. However, the PC I had to use was busted as hell. So busted that by almost every time I click on something, the PC will redirect me to an ad. A very unsafe ad. It could have been a virus. It was so funny that I decided to make a video out of it. I still remember what I did. Once upon a time, I played the game by the name of Bubble Struggle 2. I found the game so much fun that I wanted to download the game to make levels on my own. What I didn't knew was that it was impossible, because the owner of the game stated himself that he accidentally removed the feature. Oopsies. But I went to a random website, downloaded what I guess was the application, and installed it. And that's where problems were starting to rise. I had no idea how to remove the virus, and from time to time it was starting to get worse and worse. So bad that I couldn't even watch YouTube anymore before getting an ad. But once again, that was the reason why I made that video. Just to show how hilariously dumb the virus was. It was worth it. The next day, my PC returned, and things turned back to normal. It was a cold day in November, and I just got my PC back. The employee from the computer shop told me that it was worthless to download YouCam for my PC, because there was an already installed camera on the PC I could use. So I was looking for the app on my PC, and right they were. The app was just standing there and my journey with making videos continued. I however was kind of afraid the camera would be in really bad quality, meaning it wouldn't work at all. But oh boy was I wrong. Not only was my screen much less blurrier than before, it was also recorded in HD. All my other videos with YouCam and even my previous recorded Flash games were all uploaded in 480p, so this was a huge improvement. What kind of idiot was I when I thought YouCam was better when it basically was the opposite? I basically went to the shop for nothing. Bye-bye 30 euros. Whatever. At some point I wanted to record a game by the name of Mario Spot Mix. I really enjoyed the game back in the day, cause there was so much content in it. So I was also thinking to also record this game for once. I also made another video of Wii Party. The more I used the camera, the more I got used to it. And then it was time. My subscriber count was at 49 subscribers, and I had another special video in mind. Ugh. Did I just fart in the video? Ugh, gross. Whatever, this is what I had in mind for my 50 subscriber special. Okay, understandable. A reaction video, so you guys can hear my reaction if I have 50 subscribers. Pretty clean idea, but what were to also someone to subscribe to my channel at that exact moment? Oh, whoa! I actually did it! I actually recorded my reaction of me getting 50 subscribers. Plot twist, I paused the video, went to the game and asked someone to subscribe. You have gotten to be kidding me. Is that what I really did? Can we take a look through it really quick?
Als ik dat weer even poseer.
Okay, so it was obvious how in a strange miracle I got 50 subscribers on the video. I was a f***ing liar all this time, and the whole video was fake. Also, did you straight up hit the reaction when I got 50 subs? Let's hear it.
Ik heb na 5 minuten. Holy f***, hij doet het! 50 abonnees, eindelijk! Oh, eindelijk! 50 abonnees, jongens! Ja, we hebben hem! We hebben hem gewoon, we hebben hem!
Ech, whatever. I can't take it anymore to watch the video any longer. Let's move on. The next day I think I apologized by making the second part of my 50 subscriber special, and thank god this is so much better. It is just me playing Bonk.io, and I had a ton of fun with it. It was kinda laggy, but what did you expect if I have a bad PC? After my 50 subscriber special, I decided to make a few more videos of Bonk.io and eventually one of someone hacking or lagging in the game. I mean, look at him. I don't know what really happened, but at least it was fun to make a video about it. After the Bunkayao videos, I decided to go back to Mario games, or EE if you count this video of me buying the beta membership. Nah, playing Mario games was at the top of my list, because it was December 2016 and we got introduced to a new game, Super Mario Maker for the Nintendo 3DS. Since I was someone that pre-ordered the game, I thought it would be a good idea to make a video of the opening of the game. I thought it would get me a lot of views since I possibly was the first person who ever recorded the opening of the game, yet it didn't got that many views. What a shame. Throughout the period of December, I made some more Super Mario Maker 2 videos, this time being the Jaron Burrow tutorials and the credits of the game. The Jaron Burrow videos aren't available on the channel anymore, but the credits is available, and man, there's a lot to talk about this video. I still was recording with my PC camera, so the screen was already kind of blurry. What got me is that I made a lot of movements with my arm throughout the video, and then at some point, you see this. I've been wondering for years, what even is that thing? Is that my face in the dark? Is that my hand? Or is it something else? I'm not going to bother that much about it, but I'm still kind of figuring out where it could be, because I don't know myself as well. So from mid-December, I again have plans to make improvements on my content by using my phone as a camera, and looking to it, it indeed is a huge improvement. But I had one question. What should I use as a stand to make it easier to record my videos? I've been trying multiple things, using a map, stack some books on each other, and even hold my phone myself. Nothing seemed to work that well, until I came up with an idea. What if I use a tripod instead? That should fix my problem. So I bought one from the internet only to see I have to wait for a minimum of 20 workdays. This was obnoxiously stupid, but I decided to wait for it. In the meantime, I made some more videos about EE, Super Mario Maker 2, and also some fact videos, and at that point, 2016 came to a close, but I had one more video to publish before the year ends. The name was inspired by a TV show we sometimes watch in the Netherlands, but for those who don't understand it, this is just a compilation of the best moments from 2016. The video was kind of cringe, but this was my first ever edited video in my career, and I gotta be honest, for a 2016 video, it honestly looks really good. I had a decent amount of clips, I tried to make some memes, and the overall editing was pretty decent. Unfortunately, because I'm stupid sometimes, I accidentally removed some videos, which caused me to remake the whole video, since I was using YouTube Editor back in the day. Fortunately, I was able to remake the video within a day and upload the video in time, bringing 2016 to a peaceful close. After an incredible year of improving my content and never giving up hope, 2016 ended and 2017 was about to start. I had one goal in mind, make new content and improve my future videos. I still had a long way to go though. I wanted to learn more about editing, I wanted to make a channel makeover with a new PFP and channel art, and I especially was looking forward to finally receive my tripod about a few weeks from then. With that thing, I will be able to get access to so much more things. Just because I wanted to wait for my tripod, I decided to keep it calm with my videos. Daredevil was something I really wanted to record at that time. One day, I was doing some time trials on Rainbow Road and Mario Kart Wii. When I entered the second lap of the run, I did something unimaginable. I clicked on one of the walls to float higher in the air at the moon jump. Since I've never seen someone doing that before, I thought it was too assisted only, so I decided to make a video out of it and upload it. And here is the result.
Nou, het lijkt op een tastmoment, maar dat is het gewoon niet.
That was pretty hilarious to actually pull off. But yes, the video is only 26 seconds long, but after just one look on the video, you again saw a massive improvement. Don't notice it? Look at the title real quick. Yep, that's right. This was the first video ever on my channel where I used capital letters in my title. That doesn't sound like it's something big, but from my perspective, I was finally starting to take YouTube more serious there. But since my tripod wasn't arrived yet, I decided to move on with everybody edits for a few videos. One of the videos was like Curseboard, but differently. It was better though. But the other video was me announcing that I will stop recording PC games for a temporary moment, since my tripod was about to arrive. So say goodbye to these videos, for now at least. A few days after my announcement, my tripod arrived, and it was about time to get things ready to upgrade my content to the next level. With my tripod finally being there, I immediately took action for new videos. One of the biggest ideas I had in mind was to make Let's Plays. The first Let's Play was for New Super Mario Bros. Wii, a more simplistic game to Let's Play. Because I just got started, this was the best idea I had back then. And oh man, that is so much better than recording with your PC. Finally, no more blurriness, just how it needs to be. Clean and simple. It also was recorded in full HD, which made it even better. That combination was ideal for me back then. After a few videos of the Let's Play, I decided to also keep my eye on something else and something bigger I also had in mind for months. Yep, live streaming. But to get myself prepared for that, I recorded some videos of Mario Kart 7 to see if I'm eligible for streaming the game. And to be honest, yes, I was. After a few tests, I finally made my decision to go live for the first time. But man, it went horrible. The thing is, I had a great time, but only for 30 minutes. Yep, that's right. My streaming software decided to stop after 30 minutes. I mean, it wasn't bad or anything. Sure, every streaming software has some sort of cap on how long a stream can be, but only 30 minutes? Maybe it was my internet. And then there was this audio delay. I mean, just listen to it real quick.
Nou, oké, we gaan weer beginnen.
Now I feel bad for even touching that camera back then. Anyways, the streaming software I used was called Emojis Live, and unless you have good internet, I can't recommend you to try out this camera. It just doesn't work that well. Just for streaming sakes, I decided to test it one more time, and as it turned out, results were the same. I decided to just keep living with this camera, and decided to stream in a lower resolution until I got the new streaming software. But it was really annoying doing so, cause I kept being stuck on those limitations. Oh, I didn't even conclude my Let's Play of New Super Mario Bros. Wii. Let's talk about that. So this Let's Play actually turned out to be quite decent. I used custom thumbnails for the videos who were definitely not stolen for someone else. Just kidding. I didn't quit the game because I got bored, and for an overall first Let's Play recorded with my phone, it actually turned out pretty good. I also made some MK7 videos of weird glitches I discovered when I was away from home. I've seen the glitch of Koopa Cake many times before, but what even was this glitch on Maple Tree Ray? Whoa, seems like an out of bounds glitch. Seriously, I have never seen that before on YouTube. It was kind of funny to pull off. Before moving on to something big, there was yet another kind of video I wanted to try out. Challenges. Once upon a time, I tried to record a video of me recording every track of Mario Kart 7 by only pressing the A button. Call me crazy, but for some tracks, it actually works if you do the right thing. What a crazy invention. After uploading the video, I've decided to take a break from making my own original content, cause something big was about to happen. Don't you remember being around on YouTube, browsing through your favorite YouTubers only to comment on the video and hope they would respond? If you were like that, I can perfectly relate. All I hoped for back in the day was to just get one response from a YouTuber I daily watched. YouTubers like Nathaniel Bendy, SMG4, and much more creators. I knew how difficult it was going to be, but I knew if I was doing the right thing, I eventually would get a response. I tried it for months. Not even a single person replied. Sad. Until I had an idea. What if I do this on a different website that is less popular than YouTube? And that's exactly what I did. I went to a website by the name of DeviantArt. Now that has been a while since I talked about that program, and even used it. But let's make a thing clear. Back in the day, DeviantArt was my ultimate resource to talk with content creators I loved. Mainly sprite animators. And one of these sprite animators is called AsylusGoG91 Studios. Now I watch this guy's content a lot. And I really mean a lot. He owns a sprite animation by the name of SMB Heroes of the Stars. If you're a sprite animation fan, I can't recommend this series enough. Trust me, it won't be a blast. But going back to where I was, it was time to place my comment to Aspimation to make a compilation of the funniest moments of SMB Hots. And to be honest, every time I look at this comment, it makes me laugh and also cringe. I told you before that my English really sucked back in the day, and this comment was no exception. I stated, King Asylus, I hope you're back here yet, cause I have a question. Can I make a compilation of the funniest moments of your series SMB Heroes of the Stars? This is not going to work. My English was incredibly bad, and I don't think you will ever read my comment. Huh? It worked? It actually worked? Whoa! I got approval to make compilation of one of my favorite Sprite series. Yes! Seriously though, I was beyond happy when I saw this. I immediately started making the first episode of the compilation. It took like 2 days to complete. But when it was completed, the first thing I thought was, this is it. I'll get a million views on this video and I will be a popular guy on the internet. No way. Not even a single few? I didn't look for 2 to 3 hours because I was dining out. Yeah, apparently it took that long. But it was quite disappointing to see a video with a lot of potential not blowing up on my channel and in the spring community. But I didn't give up my hope yet. I had a few more episodes to make, and even the episodes with all the episodes combined, so I still had a lot of work to do, but I knew it would eventually pay off at some point. The real question was, when will it happen? The compilations were all done, and it was about time to move on with my own content. I had in mind to move on with my new Super Mario Bros. Wii Let's Play, but not before yet another special video. Because I had reached the 2.5k views milestone, and just because it was almost a year since I made content at the time, I decided to make, say it with me, a channel history. Now this video is a hell of a lot different than my older version and this version of my channel history. But let me tell you something, the 2018 version of my channel history was a remake of that video. So comparing the 2018 version to the 2017 version makes the 2017 version cringe as pineapple. But again, comparing the 2021 version with the 2018 version makes the 2018 version cringe as pineapple. Yeah, I don't know how else to describe it. But nonetheless, even though most of my critics went towards the 2017 version of my channel history, keep in mind that once again, this was one of my first edited videos in my career. And with the edit fade-ins and fade-outs, this was a huge improvement over the 2016 compilation. But my tactics for editing videos was not done yet. I was just getting started. I still strive for better editing and I will make even more improvements in the future. But like I said, I was just getting started. Moving on. After yet another glitch video of Mario Kart Wii, I decided to go back to my new Super Mario Bros. Wii Let's Play, cause there was still a lot to do. My idea was to upload as many parts as generally possible, at moments when I was home alone, and I had a great time with it. When I completed the game, I was genuinely glad I could finally move on to my next target, a Let's Play of Mario & Luigi Dream Team. It was honestly really nice I could revisit the game, since this was my first ever played Mario & Luigi RPG, and every time I play this game, it just brings back so many memories. Now this game was kind of difficult to make a Let's Play on, since this is a game where you need to use both screens. This problem especially took effect at the giant battles, where you have to hold your Nintendo 3DS vertically in order to make progress. This was incredibly obnoxious. How was I able to play the game whilst recording it to my audience and whilst I was sitting on the floor, since I had no setup back then? I mean sure, it worked out, but damn, that was way more difficult than I thought it would be. Whatever, after uploading some parts of the Let's Play, I reached 60 subs. At this point, I really started to run out of special video ideas, but thanks to someone who gave me a suggestion, I had an idea. It was a weird one though. Do Mario Kart Wii, but wait for all the computer players to reach the second lap and make a comeback afterwards. Challenge accepted. Such a stupid idea, but that's why I loved it so much. It was a blast doing this challenge. And the footage of the video holds up pretty well for a 2017 video. Going back to the Let's Play of Mario & Luigi Dream Team. I still had a lot to do, but the more I played, the more tired and bored I've gotten. All I needed was a serious break and going with something else. With the Let's Play on hold, I decided to go back to Everybody Edits and Mario Kart Wii. I had in mind to still upload some PC games here and there, but as time went on, I really wanted to focus on making more videos of Mario games, cause I had enough equipment to still make really good videos with my phone. After doing that for a while, I was ready to take on my next step. Around the end of April, I decided to finally get a new streaming software. This time, I went for Camera Feed Live. I was so done with Emojis Live that I had to make this decision. And man, it felt so good to finally stream in HD again. And that I finally got rid of that obnoxious cap like my old streaming software had. I streamed for a total of 45 minutes and I didn't have a single problem for the entire stream. A few days after the stream, I've reached my next milestone, 75 subscribers. So I decided to stream Smash Bros. For the Nintendo 3DS, cause you know, Smash is always a really overhyped game that a lot of people play. But to be honest, after just a few matches of the game, I already did regret my decision to stream this game at all. The game was good, but when I mentioned lag and peer-to-peer, it completely ruins it. Most of the matches I played in the stream were all ruined by it, and I already was horrible in the game. Peer-to-peer decided to add some extra spice to it. Seriously, how are you guys so good with this lag? Ugh, Nintendo really needs to fix the servers at some point. But that didn't really matter. What mattered was that I started a new journey on YouTube. The journey of daily live streaming. My god. I have so many memories when it comes to this topic. Like at the very first stream where I've gotten 9 concurrent viewers. The fact that I've made more friends than ever. Like guys like Dutch Gengar, Nibiru, Mystic, Wouter, and the list goes on. I even talk and play some games with some of them to this very day. It is the coolest thing ever. And also memories from MK7 itself, since that was the game I streamed back in the day. I literally didn't touch MK7 for longer than 2 years now, so I honestly would love to pick it up again and stream this game like the old days. As I kept moving forward with these daily livestreams, these livestreams were starting to get busier and busier, eventually getting me over 10 concurrent views on the Mario Party 9 livestream. That's right, at a certain point I also decided to throw some more games into the bunch, mainly MP9 due to its large promotion of YouTube. A few of these streams are currently one of my most watched streams on my channel, reaching almost 1,000 views each. That is an insane amount for just a game where luck is the pinnacle. I also tried to record WarioWare Smooth Moves, but that stream didn't really go that well. Still though, I had a ton of fun with it. And also, we need to talk about this Bonk.io stream I also did in May. The first question you might have is, how did I stream Bonk.io if I don't know how OBS works? Simple, I actually streamed with OBS there because I just realized the problem that caused me to have a black screen actually relied on myself. Cause, you guessed it, I didn't have any source open back in the day. How idiotic. Not only have I broken viewer records on my channel, but also subscriber records. And within just a few weeks, I gained a total of 25 subscribers, counting to a total of 100 subscribers. I decided to go crazy this time, cause 100 subscribers typically is one of the first major milestones you will achieve on your channel. I decided to make a 5-hour stream of 5 different games. This included Mario Party 9, Mario Kart Wii, WarioWare Smooth Moves, Mario Kart 7, and Super Smash Bros. For the Nintendo 3DS. All my previous streamed games on my channel in one giant stream. What could go wrong with that? I again had a crap ton of fun making that stream, even though it didn't go watch that much, but keep in mind what my main phrase was, I don't make content to get attention, I make content cause I like it. This can be seen everywhere on my channel. I mostly just go out of my way to make videos that are longer than an hour and still won't be happy even when they reach like 50 views. I do it because editing is my hobby and I really want to keep my viewers happy and surprised with my videos. That had to be said, but moving on. After 5 hours of live streaming to my channel, it was time to move on. Now that I've completed all the boards for Mario Party 9, it was time to move on to stream every single board in Mario Party 8. Well, almost every board. I remember that I got bored at some point and moved on with Mario Kart 7 again. But a quick fact. I've told you before that YouTube loves to support Mario Party 9 videos. Funny enough, my most watched stream on my channel is this stream for Mario Party 8 with a total of 1300 views. That is quite a lot for, once again, just a game where luck is the pinnacle. Meh, I guess luck is just a popular topic. But afterwards, I got kinda bored with Mario Party 8 and I decided to go back to Mario Kart 7 and eventually Mario Party 9 here and there. For MK7, it was just like how I did normally. Race with my friends to get higher VR. For MP9 on the other hand, I decided to go with the side modes of the game. Modes like Boss Rush, High Rollers, Step It Up, you know it by now. It was kinda funny how for one of these streams I decided to only stream for 8 minutes, but I guess it paid off afterwards. I also tried to stream Sonic Generations for the 3DS for once, but that didn't really go that well. I just decided to move on with MK7 and MP9, cause those were the two easiest games to stream for me. After a month of daily live streaming, I was about to achieve another few milestones and also something even bigger. Up in June 2017, the next big milestone I achieved was 10k YouTube views. And this milestone meant something big for me. As a special video, I made a stream of me playing random Mario Party 9 minigames, but that wasn't a big deal. The big deal was that YouTube still had the old guidelines of the monetization, meaning that with 10k views you could already monetize your channel no problem. I didn't know of it before, but someone from my school told me about it. He told me about an AdSense account and I had no idea where he was talking about since, well, I was always bad at following information, but it didn't matter. When I was back home, I decided to get into action to get my channel ready for monetization. I followed all the policies and made my AdSense account. When I completed it, it was all for the waiting game, waiting patiently to get paid out. I made some more MK7 streams in the meanwhile though, nothing new, just me racing and hoping to get higher VR, and then it was July 1. I was hasting to my AdSense account to see if anything happened, and as it turned out, nothing happened. I thought I did something wrong, but I decided to leave it there for a second. At a certain point I was already at 150 subscribers. This time I decided to go back to Mario Party 9 once again to do a perspective mode stream, which now is my most watched Mario Party 9 livestream with a total of 900 views. Quite insane if you ask me, since I remember not getting that many views when I streamed the game, although guess YouTube recommended to some viewers. After a day or 10, I decided to check my AdSense again, and lo and behold, there was actually money on it now. Only 37 cents though, but back in the day I was like, you know what, every cent counts. And I was really happy to finally see I could monetize my channel. This was honestly a dream for many years for me. As much as I didn't care about viewers, I certainly cared a lot about getting paid out on my channel. And to this day, I honestly still do. Oh, you remember when I said I wanted a new PFP and channel art for my channel? Well, someone by the name of Dane B, or at least I guess you pronounce his name like that, asked me if I needed a new PFP and channel art. And since I didn't really got anything, I decided to go with it. It took him a few days to make, but damn, it was all for the better. Now it was really time to make made my channel stand out. And with my new PFP and channel art added to my channel, I also attempted to make my first channel intro. Now this video is honestly cringe as hell nowadays, but once again, this was one of my first edited videos, my first attempt on the channel intro, so for those standards, it's honestly quite decent, thus being a bit on the long side, but at least I knew what to do, so the video wasn't that bad. After some more Mario Kart 7 livestreams, I thought it was about time to heat up my livestreams a bit. It was about time to install a mod for Mario Kart Wii. I still remember July 25, 2017 when I got a new Mario Kart Wii disc and booted up CTGP for the first time. Damn, those are such old times. I've been wanting to play CTGP since 2011 and I've been working on installing the mod for the past 2 months. The main thing I was afraid of was that I already had an hacked Wii with an HDD installed on it. I was scared that as soon as I installed something on my Wii, my hard drive or even my entire Wii would not be working anymore. But as it turned out, I was wrong and they still work to this day. Whatever, back to CTGP. After playing for a while, I already had a ton of fun with it. A total of 216 tracks included instead of the normal 32. That's quite a lot, isn't it? I was so excited that I've made a lot of videos on livestream to show how good this mod really was. It was, and still is my favorite mod in any video game of all time. Throughout this time, I also focused on playing Mario Kart 7 here and there. Doing that for a while, and I've met a guy by the name of Raystar. This guy went out of his way to write down a comment on one of my livestreams. Unfortunately, because I think the comment got removed, I can't really show it to you, but I think I still know what he said. Something like, "Great stream. It's good to still see you're actively streaming." Now at first I thought this was just a random person that wanted to add me on Skype, when Skype was still a hype back in the day. But after chatting with him for a while, I knew he was different than any other friend I've met with these Mario Kart 7 livestreams. We were chatting a lot more, we were calling a lot more, we also realized we play and watch the same games, and we got the same humor, which made it an even bigger coincidence. Roy also told me that it was a complete joke that he wrote a comment on my video, since he almost never does that. And to be honest, I was really thankful for that, but I will explain later why. Going back to the livestreams, I still was actively streaming CTGP, even though I didn't have Vimfire yet, the online service of the game. I thought the game had more than enough content without Vimfire to still be a lot of fun. I mainly focused on doing time trials to beat personal bests. After doing them all tracks, I just redid them to improve my time even more. But it made the game a bit less fun than before, since you already played those tracks before. But it was more. Updates. Now, I was kind of scared that if I updated my CTGP, my Wii would run into issues, since with updates you also need internet, and since internet also was a cause that stopped my HDD, I was kind of sitting in a dead end. But I decided to update it anyways, and to my surprise, it actually works! And so my journey with CTGP continued, but I was dealing with something else around that time. August 15, 2017, another one of those days I won't forget that quickly. After waking up, taking a shower and going downstairs, my parents wanted to talk with me. Sure, maybe it was something to be excited about. Wow, that came out of seemingly nowhere. It was so shocking that I've got an emotion over it for the rest of the day. But I also understood their situation. They didn't want to live together anymore and it was time to move on. Around that time I've also reached the 200 subscribers milestone and it was about time to go back to YouTube. The day after the horrible news, I decided to move on with YouTube because I've reached the 200 subscribers milestone. I wanted to stream Mario Kart 7 for 200 minutes. It went quite bad since my internet decided to not work properly. Meh, it happens. But I remembered using a different streaming software there because I was running into issues with camera feed live. Mostly when I streamed in 720p, the screen glitched out like crazy, so that's why some people told me I had to use this streaming software for YouTube instead. But like I said, this didn't work well either, so after using it for a while, I decided to go back to camera feed live. Meh, it happens. The news was still in my mind and I didn't have hope for a good future, but still, it didn't convince me to stop live streaming in any way possible. I made some more CTGP and MK7 streams throughout this period and my summer vacation was slowly starting to come to an end. So it was time to get my school equipment ready for the next school year. Whilst doing that, my parents were also discussing about what will happen, about when I will move to my father and then to my mother, about getting a new Wii for me. Wait, did they just say getting a new Wii for me? A Wii that can handle internet unlike the Wii I had here? Whoa, that is some insane news. I still can play online on Mario Kart Wii. Haven't done that in a while. I was so happy to hear that news. My future was finally improving again. After doing some more streams of Mario Kart Wii and Mario Kart 7, my father had something else in mind that also was shocking. He told me, "Yuk, wouldn't you like it to have a television in your bedroom? I find it quite annoying to hear the sound of your game all day long." Holy crap. I didn't expect any of my parents would say something like that to me. But now I was truly looking forward to the future. Still though, I felt bad for my parents that they have made the decision, but I at least was happy for the decision they've made for me. And so school was starting and I had to make a decision due to homework. I had to stream much less than I normally did. It was a difficult decision, but I had no other choice. So in mid-September 2017, I was thinking to go yet again back to Everybody Edits, because I've been working on something for the past few days. A pure recreation of my old 2016 video, a recreation of all the Rainbow Road tracks, but with a twist. This time being spread around in 8 rolls and fully made by a bot. And to be honest, it looks incredible. This also was my first ever uploaded video with a 3D fight intro, and now that I mention about this topic, I completely forgot that I've also started to use intros in my videos. My first intros were all created in Penzoid, a pretty basic tool to make your intros with. It worked, but I found it too generic, but that will all be fixed in the future. Going back to the video, and it's weird that I've never realized it before, but this was my last ever recorded EE video on my channel. No wonder why it was such a big project. Besides the lag problems, the video honestly was pretty solid. Adding some text and images when the next race was about to start, and I also added some fitting music to it. I honestly was really happy with this video. In the meantime, I made some more videos about Mario Kart Wii, Sonic Generations glitches, and much more. Going back to May for a second, I forgot to mention this Sonic Generations 3DS glitch where I showed this time on the final boss of the game, cause I got a world record on it, but I'm not entirely sure on that cause the game is using an in-game leaderboard on Time Attack, so even though it says I'm number 1 there, there could be a chance that people play the stage in the story mode. Still though, I see it as a world record, so that's that. Going back to the future. Also something I had in mind to do for months was to make custom BRSCMs for the tracks in Mario Kart Wii, since I just noticed you could actually do that. Though, since it was 2017, I had no idea how to make any of it, but Royster certainly did, since he also told me he had a lot of knowledge about how stuff on your PC works, which also is going to be important for later. But moving off with the BRSCMs, he made some BRSCM files for me to add into my SD card. After doing that a few times, he wanted to explain me how to make BRSCMs. It took a while for me to understand because I can be an idiot sometimes, but after some moments, I have officially made my first BRSCM, with Roy's help of course. Roy told me I should try it out myself, cause if I don't, I probably forget what to do in order to make it, and that's how I learned how to make BRSCMs. Thanks Roy, I own you. After doing several Mario Kart 7 livestreams, I decided to do a Mario Kart 7 livestream with Roy, and damn, it went way too off topic. I was just doing my stream. The longer I streamed, the less I took the stream serious. After 20 minutes, I decided to just go out of my way and troll, saying yo when I felt or did something funny. That really convinced Roy to join the VC 20 minutes later to also troll me and others throughout the stream. And here's the first example. Oh nee, daar heb je hoor. Yeah. Oh yeah, you're in the net. Why? Just why did you have to do that, Roy?
Ja, dan komt hij nog. Toe, dan komt hij nog een keer.
He did it again. Wow, that's rude. I just note all the funny moments from this stream in this video.
Nee, maar dat wou ik helemaal niet zeggen. Ik bedoel, ik ben klaar met de video. En ik kon nog een keer ineens bevat auteursrechten beschermen, dan komt het. Je hebt je erin zijn. Ja, ik herken dat wel. Ik heb dus serieus.
Ik probeer het echt op je allerbest te zeggen. Ik probeer het echt op je allerbest.
Oké. Nee. Ik vind nog iets beters. Sorry, ik kan het echt niet. Ik doe het echt gewoon als het me eer geeft.
Wat heeft al die internet hier?
Wat? Nee. Nee. Hij had hier al voor even neergezet. Hij heeft serieus zichzelf ja genoemd. Dat zie je zo wel.
Jezus, joh. Are you kidding me? Kom, ik zat derde.
Ja, is goed. Denk Express. Hoe vind je dit zien, jongens? Ik heb echt zo'n goed idee, hè? Ik heb echt zo'n goed idee. Jongens, van degene die live kijken, ik wil... Gaat die hacken? Nee. Weet je... Nee, ik moet echt gewoon een keer een troll doen. Moet je mij kijken op map? Ja. Oh. Dit kan echt niet meer. Oh nee, ik ben nog iets beters. Ik ga achteruit. Nee.
Ja.
Ik heb ook disconnect. Tot de volgende keer.
Fantastisch. Tot de volgende
keer. Oké. Wat de f*** is dat dan weer voor iets?
Oké, dat was somewhat weird, but hey, I had a great stream. And at a given moment, Ray and I decided to stop since we knew how annoying it can be if we continue with it. But once again, I had some great loss. I decided to still go on with trolling on my livestreams, but Ray wasn't really available. It was funny though, but a few streams later, a magical moment happened where people still talk about to this day.
Holy s***, kijk hem gaan.
I didn't know myself what would happen, moved on with my stream. Upon finishing it, Roy sent me a clip via Skype that seemed kind of familiar. It's the voice clip I just made. When I listened to it myself, I knew this voice clip would have some huge potential for my future videos, so I decided to upload it myself. And seemingly, this was one of my fastest growing video a day one of the upload. I got like 100 views within a day, and that was something huge for me back in the day. Then it was time to make yet another stream with Ray the Troll again. And man, that ending was straight up hilarious. The clip itself was 8 minutes, but I will show you a few seconds of it.
Ik ga niet afleiden nu. Jongens, allemaal vergeet niet te liken en te abonneren. Ik hoop dat jullie dit een leuke stream vonden, maar ik zie jullie allemaal volgende keer wel weer in de volgende stream. Meen je dit nou echt?
Now that's a fun way to end your stream. After a few more streams, I decided to hack my 3DS with Roy's help. This is what my video looked like after hacking my 3DS. I did download an application for my 3DS by the name of KitKat, my updater, which allows you to duplicate your 3DS screen to your PC, just like how a capture card does, except without sound and one of the screens running at 1 FPS to save CPU storage. I was able to explain all of that in my video, but there was one major regret in this video. How and why didn't I credit Roy for helping me installing custom firmware? He literally spent over an hour explaining me how to install custom firmware for your 3DS. Now I feel sorry for him for not getting the credits he deserved for doing that. Whatever, screw that for now. I had a bright future for live streaming at this point, having both CDGP for Mario Kart Wii and KitKat no update for my 3DS. Now before going through the 3DS stuff, I want to head back into Mario Kart Wii, cause this time I met a guy by the name of Enzo, one of the best, if not the best Mario Kart Wii players in the Netherlands. This also was someone I called a lot back in the day. Enzo was mostly there to learn me some tricks and ultra shortcuts hidden in Mario Kart Wii, especially in the custom tracks. We played quite a lot together back in the day, and it was a ton of fun. Now going back to the 3DS part, the first thing I wanted to do was to complete my Dream Team Let's Play. I decided to slowly move on with the game in the period of June till the end of October, and I eventually ran into a huge problem, the YouTube editor being taken down. I now had to use a new editor. I tried out some new editors. I started with Filmora. That editing software was really good, but this software had a watermark in it because it was a paid editor. After Filmora, I decided to move on with the typical Windows Movie Maker. Thus not having 60 FPS anymore, it still was a great editor, and it was exactly what I needed to finish Dream Team and go on with my upcoming projects. It took like ages to complete, but I finally completed the game and I was really happy when I did. Going back to MK7, and to be honest, the first stream went really well. The only problem I had was the lag sometimes, but even that was understandable. The thing is, the application I used relies on your internet. The better your internet, the higher your frame rate. And since I had pretty horrible internet, the frame rate was between 15 and 30, sometimes even a flat zero. Even though this was a huge problem, I still was thankful to even record my 3DS like that in the first place. Who would have thought this was a thing you could do? I went on with streaming this game till the end of the year, trying out some new things, like playing the game with inverted colors or hacking the game. I still remember that I made one stream only to realize that my entire audio was turned off. Yeah, kinda stupid. But the more I went on, the closer we were at the end of 2017. I decided to take a break for a week to focus yet again on something big. With my livestreams on hold, I decided to go back to this time make yet again a compilation of the series I made funny scenes of, but this time I made the fight scenes. I again got permission from my silent coaching to make the compilation, so I again had a lot of work to do. Going back to the funny scenes, I had one question. Here's it again, all the episodes combined, so I still had a lot of work to do, but I knew it would eventually pay off at some point. The real question was, when will it happen? And to answer that question, yes, it kinda blew up. Some videos still were on a pretty low amount of views, but some of the videos were close to reach 1,000 views. That was a huge amount for me back in the day. But what did you expect if the series is so popular even to this day? With most of the episodes completed, I decided to keep the phone movie and the remastered episodes on hold again, because I had a lot of work to do with my own 2017 compilation. I wanted to make a compilation of the top 50 funniest moments of the year. It took a while to make that video, but I again was able to upload the video in time. And starting from this video, my editing was really starting to shine. I used more effects, fade ins and fade outs, and I really was starting to take my videos more serious here. I've learned that by editing videos, you don't have to add too much text and only use full caps if it is necessary. And with that video being uploaded, it was time to say goodbye to 2017. And again, I have made many changes that year, from making Let's Plays to making daily livestreams. It was a true blast. And now it was January 2018. This year started really good on one side and really rough on the other side. On the plus side, I finally returned with livestreaming and also some normal videos. Let's first talk about the 250 subscribers milestone. So around that time, I finally found out how to install custom tracks that aren't in CTGP on your Wii. I've decided to make a video of all the downloaded custom tracks because they were that incredible. I was wondering why they were in the CTGP. With that, I also made some showcases of newly added tracks. This was such a blast to do back in the day. Now onto live streaming. I was finally able to play on my new Wii and I had to set it up before playing on it. But that wasn't that much of a deal. It took a week before I finally could play on Wi-Fi, which was a dream come true for me around that time. And I really wanted to live stream it. However, I was really starting to get tired of these streams. So I made the decision to stream much less than I normally did. I again also focused on doing time trials on custom tracks. I also wanted to record the track by the name of Impossible Road. I really wanted to know how long it would take me to finish the race. However, due to one major mistake I've made, I finished the track in 21 minutes. I kept doing that ultra shortcut at the start of the track and every time I fell, lagging to respawn me back at the start. If I didn't do that, I could finish the track within 4 minutes with ease. But the more I went into Wi-Fi, the less fun doing time trials became, so I decided to just focus on playing online. I did this quite a lot and it was quite enjoyable, but now on to MK7. And there was one problem I was dealing with for over 2 months at the time, the fact that I had a corrupted SD card in my Nintendo 3DS. That really was a problem since a lot of apps weren't working anymore. Luckily I was able to get help from another 3DS hacker by the name of The Hacker 2018. After some time, I was finally able to get my custom firmware back from my Nintendo 3DS and my journey with hacking continued. Now on to the last good thing, and that of course was to complete the compilations of the SMB Hot series. All I had to upload were the compilations of the film movie and the remastered episodes. I was really happy with those videos, and I was glad I could finally move on with my own stuff. Now moving on to the rough stuff. Breaking up actions were finally starting to take place, and I had a lot of troubles with moving from house to house every Sunday. This was such a difficult situation I was in around the time. But the more we did it, the more I got used to it, and just after a month, things finally seemed to go back to normal again. At least, that's what I guessed. After a certain point, I decided to give myself a well-deserved break from either making videos and livestreams. The situation I was in was a little too much for me around that time. Daily livestreaming for almost a whole year, moving from house to house, and school was all standing in my way, and I really could have used some rest. But it was understandable, because I only was 16 years old around that time. What made being around on YouTube even worse than it needed to be was that YouTube decided to update the guidelines for the monetization. Now you need 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours to monetize your channel. I was incredibly disappointed when I saw this news, but I didn't give up my hope yet. It was time to head to 1,000 subscribers. In the meanwhile, I still enjoyed my break. I played games like Mario Kart Wii, Mario Kart 7, some Mario Luigi games, and much more. It also has been a month since I uploaded those compilations, and seemingly out of nowhere, the film movie exploded with views, getting me almost 1,000 views within a day. That was incredible. I, however, was kind of disappointed it didn't blow up a bit earlier, since YouTube just took away my monetization. And since I monetized those videos back in the day, I could have gotten a lot of money from it, but whatever. Around the start of March, I was thinking of upcoming videos I could possibly upload and how I should make them. It took me some time, but I was able to come up with some ideas. Around the end of March, it was time to go back to YouTube. It was March 21, 2018, and I uploaded this short video of a glitch in Mario Luigi Superstar Saga and Bowser's Minions. It was a pretty weird glitch, and again, I have never seen it before. After yet another compilation of a project from the Silent Goji 91, I decided to also go back to livestreaming. Again about Mario Kart V Online races via WinFi, but only for once. See, the thing is, I mentioned about making upcoming projects, and it was finally time to take some action on that. The first idea I had in mind was to make a top 10 list of best custom threads feed by boy Wouter, since he also wanted to join in the video. The list was pretty obnoxious with pretty horrible picks, but the thing is, I was and still am really bad at making top 10 videos. Mostly I just pick random tracks, and the only tracks that are accurate are number 5 to 1. I honestly hate to say that, but it's true. But nonetheless, starting from this video, I was starting to also make English content, since my English somewhat improved over time, and that was a huge change, even to this day. After the top 10 video, I've reached the 300 subscribers milestone, so here was my next idea. I've been thinking of it for a long time, releasing the first version of my music pack. The music picks could have been better, a lot better, but this was my first ever music pack I've released, so I give it that. The only major problem with this video was the footage. Since I had no capture card, I had to use my tripod, which made some huge compressions in the audio. If you listen closely, you can also hear me and my controller controlling the game. Other than that, it was a pretty solid video for a first ever released music pack. Finally, after a countless amount of months, it finally looked like I could continue with my channel. That was until... Again? I was getting tired of all these fatal errors on my PC, and it also happened on a Sunday, meaning that the computer shop wasn't opened. Damn, fixing a PC sure can take a long time. It was really annoying, but when the shop opened again, I decided to leave it there. I got it back safe and sound not a short after that, but I was still extremely annoyed with the things that happened in these past months. So yet again, I gave myself a break for a month. However, was something I really wanted. A new intro. See, I was stuck on using this self-made penciled intro from a year ago. All the newer intros have gotten complaints for eventual epilepsy and earache triggers. And that was not something I wanted for my intros, so I went on social media to ask if someone could possibly make a new intro. And as it turned out, there was a certain someone that accepted the request. This was the intro the person made for me. Unfortunately, since the music has a copyright claim in it, I can add the sound to it, so I'll just show it like that. And to be honest, it looks really clean and well made. Shortly after I re-uploaded the video, I realized the boo was the person who made the intro. After my intro was made, it took me yet another 3 weeks to get back to YouTube. When I returned, I had in mind to upload a top video, the top 5 reasons how Nintendo triggers me. Of course, heavily inspired by Nintendo Bendy's trigger videos. The opinions I had were pretty reasonable, going from expensive games to copyright copyright claim your videos for using the music. This also was the first time that I recorded voice clips. This was a nice touch. Of course, since this was my first time I used voice clips, I was not used to making scripts, so I had a lot of slips of the tongues. And can we please just take a look to that part I spoke English? For those who haven't heard it yet, get prepared for it. You're probably cringe.
En wat eronder staat? This ban is effective in the immediality and request to remove the ban will not be processed.
I can try to reread that sentence now. This ban is effective immediately and request to remove the ban will not be processed. Much better. I had to say that again. The video has its flaws and problems, but for its time it was a pretty nice video. I had some more videos in mind for the next 2 weeks, but because I didn't work on them for a while, I decided to scrap them. I however made some streams of a giveaway. Like many other videos, this video isn't available anymore, but like I said, I was hosting a giveaway. I played music on the track and people had to guess where the song came from. Of course it was from Diddy Kong Racing, but I meant it like, where have you heard this song before on my channel? Pretty solid giveaway, but the results were an absolute disaster, which made me remove the video because of it. Nobody, and I literally mean nobody, participated in the giveaway. So there you go, I hosted the giveaway for nothing. How confident. May 2018 was about to come to an end, so I decided to move on with making videos and livestreams, until May 28th. The day Enzo sent me a message on Discord that he has bought a capture card, and so I got jealous and I also wanted one. After some discussing with my parents, they finally came with an answer. My god, that was such a pleasant surprise. I was finally allowed to buy a capture card. This, my guys, has been a dream for me for the past 2 years. At the exact date my first video was uploaded, and now I've bought it. It took a few days before it got delivered, but I didn't care about that. It was all for the greater. And then, the day was finally there. My capture card arrived, and we had to pick it up from the shops that were close to our house. And my god, I was so happy when I finally got my hands on the first ever capture card. Now, since I'd never touched a capture card in my life before, I of course had no idea how to set it up. So I asked Enzo what to do to set up my capture card. There was a problem though. Enzo had the Elgato capture card and I had an AVerMedia one. After figuring out on how an AVerMedia capture card works, Enzo found out the problem. I had no USB cable and no V2 HDMI, which were both necessary to record your Wii. So I once again bought those from the internet. When they arrived, it was about time to stream me setting up the capture card. And Enzo once again was there. But still, nothing seemed to work. Changing channels, replugging cables, reboot my Wii, reinstalling the software. Absolutely nothing. I was about to end my stream till Enzo came with another suggestion. Trying to change HDMI in with HDMI out and HDMI out with HDMI in. And out of a miracle, that actually worked. And out of my reaction, you could already hear I was really happy that it finally worked out. Take a listen.
Ja, ik... Jongens, mijn tv... Holy s***! Enzo, je bent een legend. Okay?
Now that that problem was solved, it was time to test my recording. Gosh, it was so good. Certainly a lot better than recording with your phone. The video wasn't in HD and widescreen though, but it was still good enough to still be a massive upgrade. After uploading some more videos, I also decided to attempt a livestream, but due to my horrible PC, I had to set my resolution, framerate and bitrate to its absolute lowest. Only 480p, 30fps and 500 bits. Going any higher than that caused insane lagging on my livestream. This was a problem, but this eventually will be solved for later. Then I reached the 350 subscribers milestone, and since just after the day I reached the milestone, a new update came out in CTGP. So I thought it was a good idea to upload a video of all the newly added custom tracks in CTGP. Of course with commentary. Well, leave the commentary out of the window. I mean, listen at this.
Nou jongens, een van de meerdere interessante updates van GP Mario Beats. Nou, deze track is al veranderd. Daar kan ik wel zeggen. Dit is versie 2.1a.
Okay, I mean sure. This was my first ever video on my channel where I used commentary voice recording with my capture card, but can you please hire the volume next time? Just saying. Otherwise, this video was quite decent. It still showed all the new tracks added to CTGP, so I give it that. After about a month of uploading both videos to my channel, me and someone else were about to discover something huge, something that would change uploading videos forever. Let's first talk about the setting on the Wii I didn't change for 8 years. Literally, it was just standing there. Selecting the option will cause your Wii to run on 60fps instead of 30. How have I never seen that before? Now onto the good stuff. And when I say good, I mean really good. This guy by the name of MK Mir, which also was a friend of Enzo by the way, came to me to say cracking Premiere Pro was possible. Now back in the day, I had no idea what Premiere Pro was, but Mir explained me you could edit literally everything with this software. Getting rid of the 3x2 screen of Mario Kart Wii, run your videos at 60fps, and much, much more. And that really convinced me to crack the software as well. So MK Mir sent me a tutorial on how to do it. It took me ages to crack, but after all, it was worth it. But now onto our next step, editing a video. I did a quick test on Yuke Circuit. Yeah, apparently that was an existing track, don't ask me how. The whole video was one huge joke. When the video was ready, it was time to move on to Premiere Pro. Now back in the day, I had zero knowledge about the software, so Mir had to explain all of it. Import the video in the software, changing the resolution and all of that crap. When I did that for the first time, my honest thought was after doing all of that, the resolution of the video would still be in 480p 25fps. But I was wrong. When I uploaded the video, the resolution seemed to be in 720p 60fps. I was genuinely relieved when I saw that. I was finally able to upload videos again in high resolution. After uploading some videos, I was starting to get used to the software and was finally starting to upload more videos. With that being said, I tried to start a new series of Mario Kart Wii. Because I had to use the lowest specs possible for my streams, I was like, why not uploading videos with me playing Mario Kart Wii instead? They are much higher quality and equally the same. But it wasn't a livestream, which made live commentary impossible. I thought this was a pretty nice replacement instead of livestreaming to the channel, but after doing this a few more times, I already became bored and tired of it and continued with livestreaming. Around mid-August 2018, I've made the decision to remake my old music pack, but with some new musics added that weren't fitting well in my old music pack. I however edited the video with Windows Movie Maker, but I re-rendered the video in Premiere Pro to have a widescreen. Why? Well, I didn't exactly know how Premiere Pro worked, and I was afraid a lot of tools wouldn't be working. So I decided to focus on Windows Movie Maker for a bit. With that being said, I also focused on the Mario Kart compilation. The videos were still in 30fps, but the idea was pretty nice and it also worked really well. It didn't take me that long to make the video, since all I had to do was to just record Mario Kart Wii all the time and clip the best parts to add them in the video. The video was really solid and I really went all out on this beam somewhere halfway through. This meme means a lot to me since I just reused this meme well back in the streaming compilation.
Right now. Wait, my controller fell off. Dang it.
Ow.
That was such a fun moment. However, I still didn't learn anything of Premiere Pro, but that would all change really soon. Around this period, I've met Tekka. Now, this guy isn't really playing the usual on my channel, but he was such a supportive person. He even made a new intro for me, and I have used it for a long time. With the new intro included, it was finally time to start my journey with Premiere Pro, starting with my channel update from 2018 and 2019. I was slowly starting to understand the basics of editing, like editing the position, scaling your footage, using text in your video. Now I do think a lot of you guys know I'm working with scripts nowadays. Back in the day however, I didn't use a script at all, which was the reason why I had so many slips of the tongues. All my recorded voice clips in this video was just one giant recording, one for each part of the video, and my god, it was miserable. The editing of this video was great. The voice clips were a nightmare. I'll just play a part of the video so you guys can understand where I'm going to.
On my laptop, als ik op HD ga, als ik op HD ga livestreamen.
That's about everything I've heard. Once again, I'm not trying to hate this video, since this still was my first fully edited video with Premiere Pro, but those voice clips just ruins everything. After livestreaming for a bit, I had something huge in mind. I wanted to remake an old video of 2017 that was incredibly outdated. Here it's... Finally, I didn't mind to remake this video for a long time. The old channel history was very old, very poorly edited, and it was way too short. That's at least what I thought back in the day. Around this time, I really had to keep it quiet with livestream because the planned release date was October 27, 2018, just a month away from then. But now it was time. Time to really show my audience what I'm capable of with my videos. And with the upload finally being done, all I can think of to this day is, nowadays it is cringe as hell, but I can't deny how an insane improvement this was over the channel update. It had a lot more to offer. More editing effects, the video was almost an hour long, the new microphone, and I finally was able to make voice clips over 2 minutes long. Finally, those slips of the tongues are out of here, for the most part. I still had some slips of the tongues here and there, but that didn't matter. What mattered was that I learned from my mistakes. Going a bit back in time, Sora mid-October 2018 Roy sent me a gift of a game we could possibly play together. The game was called Toybox Turbos. I think around 95% of you guys have never heard of it, but this is a somewhat different game than Mario Kart. It is still a sim racer though. You have to race against your opponents, but when you run out of the screen, you're out. The last person standing gets 2 points to their score. When they reach a certain amount of points, they win that match. My god, I had such a joy playing this game back in the day. Roy and I had many great laughs when me and Roy filled. I still have a livestream on my channel of that game. Unfortunately, it is unlisted, so you guys can't see it unless you have the link to the stream. If you want the link, please let me know. Now let's talk about this livestream for a bit. Me, Enzo and MKB were playing on the Mario Kart Wii distribution by the name of Vince Mario Kart Fan. The stream had many insane moments in it, like this one.
You missed him.
Wow, Mii jinxed himself, how confident. There also was a certain track in this mod by the name of Electric Shredder. Since this track was like Baby Park except a bit different, this track has caused a lot of hecticness. Sometimes even more hectic than your typical match on Baby Park. It was insane. And then there was this moment. I mean, how and why did this happen? Your typical gimmick, Yuke. A slip of the tongue of one of the easiest words you could say out there. That had to be clipped, so Roy was at it again to clip it. That was such a stupid moment, but that's why this stream was such a blast. Also, something I went back to were the competitions in Mario Kart Wii. I really wanted to replay those missions, since like playing online on Mario Kart Wii, this also was something I didn't go for the longest time. I'd love to go back to it, except the fact I got banned for 4 weeks due to a mistake I'd made earlier. It got revoked though, so that's that. I also attempted some other games like Jelly Mario Bros. Gosh. This game was such a nightmare. That last level was insanely difficult to do. These fire bars were insanely difficult to dodge. But after 30 obnoxious minutes, I was able to make it. Damn, that was difficult. But it was a ton of fun, not gonna lie. Then I moved on with the sound effects edits in Mario Kart Wii, since I just learned how the Gravel Kart tool works. This Mario voice clips edit was incredibly fun to make, and I had some great laughs with it. Currently, this video is also my most watched original video with a total of 3k views. That is quite a lot for a video that is only 45 seconds long. After making some more videos and streams, it was already December, and this month was insane. Already starting from day one, Nintendo made an announcement that absolutely nobody saw coming, including myself. They were about to remove the Nintendo Creators program and Nintendo copyright claims are no more. From this point, I really was starting on using more Nintendo O's for my videos. Now that Nintendo doesn't care about it anymore, I was finally free from something I struggled with over the past 2 years. So I was about to make a video of the news and it seems like Nintendo didn't lie about it. All the claims are removed and I was straight up stunned when I saw that. Nintendo finally did something right. With that video being made and after some more videos and streams, 2018 was about to come to an end. But not till I had another video to publish, the top 20 best moments of the year. I first had in mind to make a top 50 best moments of the year, but due to running into disk space issues on my PC, I had to lower it to 20. And once again, the new amount of edits in the video were quite an improvement over the channel history. I now learned to fade in and fade out to richest seeing a lot throughout the video. This video took a hot while to make since I had to take care of the new edits. It took me around a week to make this video, but I was able to upload it according to the release date of the trailer. And with that, 2018 was over. 2018 was such an amazing year. I have achieved many things and it felt like a true journey. But now it was 2019, generally speaking, my most inactive year for the bunch, and also the year of projects, but we will get into that later. Our journey in 2019 starts with a livestream of Mario Luigi Bowser's Inside Story, Bowser Jr.'s Journey. Since I can't play 3DS, I had access to get many 3DS titles earlier than intended. Since the game was originally meant to be released at January 25, 2019, I will have streamed the game at January 1, 2019. Man, the world of hacking games, it is amazing. So I streamed the first bit of the game to show my viewers what the game would look like. It was really enjoyable, but nothing too special besides it, except the lag here and there. Around this period, I decided to yet again download a mod for Mario Kart Wii. This time I went for Hackback. At first I had problems to launch this game, but that got fixed really fast, since all I had to do was to change my Wii language to English, since I still had my Wii language on Dutch. Now back in the day, that was something I struggled a lot with when I was at my mother, having crappy internet, really crappy internet. Mostly when I streamed there, my stream would either disconnect or lag really badly, even with the lowest specs possible for my livestream. So I took it quiet with livestreaming and focused on other things. Going back to the videos, for a while I uploaded OSTs of Mario & Luigi Bowser's Inside Story, but instead I mixed the original and the remade version to make them play at the same time. It was kind of cool to do, and a friend of mine even asked me if I would start a music channel that uploads video game OSTs like BroBRSTM and JelvaSunner does, but meh, I kept it with gaming. At some point I made the decision to not upload for a while since the USB of my bike broke and I had to get a new one. When I got a new one, it was about time to get ready for something big. After making some more streams of Mario Kart Wii and also me playing some emulators, I've reached my next subscribers milestone, 400 subscribers. To celebrate that this time, I wanted to bring it back where it all began, remaking my voice reveal, now with scripted voice clips and a better screen. It was a pretty nice idea, since once again, I was out of ideas. I did a decent job on the voice clips and they did match the original video, however, the video itself didn't really make sense. I had a mirrored screen, which wondered some people why I did that, understandable. I did it because I wanted to make it look like the original video, which also had a mirrored screen, but since you couldn't see it that well, it honestly didn't really make sense why I also brought a mirrored screen to this video, and also why Mario Kart Wii 2. That is a mod literally nobody plays. I did understand that when I made that video though, since my main focus were the voice clips, and also the edits were also a nice touch. Then after finishing the video, I again had to get myself ready to take on another project, but before moving on with that, I decided to first make a brand new intro for my channel, but this time I decided to make it myself in Premiere Pro, since I learned more than enough tools to make myself a good looking intro. And to be honest, I did a really good job on this intro if I say so myself. It was way more simplistic and shorter than all my older intros, and that was exactly what I wanted. But I still had a lot of work to do because I had reached 100k views. To really make my old videos look bad, I decided to make a top 10 of the worst videos on my channel. And if you look closely, every time I made new projects, I learned more and more effects to edit my videos. Starting with the channel update, in this video I learned the basics, scaling the video and adding text and images. At my channel history, I learned the tool to speed up or slow down your videos. I also learned how to add a black and white filter into it, but I didn't really use it that much. Then my new year special where I used the fade in and fade out tool for the first time, making my edits a lot clearer than normal. Then at my voice reveal remake, I was starting to use fade ins and fade outs for old clips to immediately move on with the next clip without a black screen. This made progressing through videos a lot faster than before, and it was a tool I really needed. At my top 10 worst videos, I was really starting to use the black and white filter, and I also learned how to add the background behind your videos. I really did change that, right? So now this video. I do think this video holds up way better than my voice reveal remake due to the edits and the voice clips in this video. I really wanted to calm my voice a bit and be a more serious guy, and in my opinion, that worked. The opinions on the list once again weren't the best, but like I said before, I'm not that gonna make a top 10 list, so that was understandable. When the video was done, I decided to go back to stream Mario Kart Wii, but not too much. School exams were nearing and I had to get ready to make a schedule for my channel. March 2019, a month I had something big in mind. Of course, revealing my upcoming projects, which will be important for later, but also something else. I wanted to make a schedule for my channel so it's easier to navigate for my videos. The schedule I had planned had three kinds of videos on it: Wednesday videos, Saturday streams, and useless Sundays. I made this because I wanted to see if I get more views with this. Okay, I told you before I didn't really care about getting viewers, but I just wanted to try out. I made videos of Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door, Super Mario 64 Chaos Edition, and some more games, and I had a fun time. But after just a few weeks, I got extremely tired of it. Most of the time, I either had no new ideas for videos or a lot of ideas for videos. This is such a miserable experience. At some point, I couldn't resist it anymore, and I decided to go back to normal again. There are even worse videos I made throughout this period, like this huge slip of the tongue on my livestream.
Yeah, of the bubble bike of the... What have you doing?
Another one of those clips that get memed a lot. It is hilarious. And also this clip. A first version of Ye was born. Do I have anything to say about this? I also have gotten a new outro since I had an outro before and I used it for the longest time. Around 2 years to be exact. It really was time to get a new one. After making more videos, streams and learning from my exams, I once again had the mind to get myself ready for the next wave of projects. Exams were finally done, and I finally had more free time than ever, so it was about time to work on my newest installment of my music pack, version 2.0. This video came out on the exact day the first version of my music pack turned 1 year old. I thought it was a good idea to upload version 2.0 on the exact date a year later. To keep it simple, this music pack was a massive upgrade over version 1.0 and 1.5 combined. The musics were finally starting to make more sense, and I started to also use new music since Nintendo threw the copyright system away. I had a lot more choices than ever, and it finally wasn't that much of a nightmare anymore to make music packs like the old days. Overall, I'm really happy how this music pack stands, even though this isn't my newest installment of my music pack since I just released version 3.0 back in April this year. Then I had a mind to make a tutorial on how to edit videos like me. Of course, heavily outdated nowadays, but besides the bad frame rate, this video was very solidly put together. I showed most of the tools I've worked with back in the day and I gave the viewers some sort of idea how I edited my videos, but like I said, nowadays it is really outdated. However, I have planned to remake this video in 2022, with again the tools I've edited throughout the years, so keep an eye on that. Whilst I kept being stuck on Mario Kart Wii with livestreaming, I really wanted to focus a bit more on videos. I made the final part of Mario Kart Wii HD in widescreen, Paper Mario 64, Gmod, some 12 videos, and a trailer of the next big project, GameYuke's Epic Moments Montage, Ultimate Edition. This video was originally meant to only have Mario Kart Wii clips included, but remember what I told you in the previous chapter? Let's replay it. I first had in mind to make a top 50 best moments of the year, but due to running into disk space issues on my PC, I had to lower it to 20. Oh yeah, of course, the disk space. How am I ever supposed to make a video that big with this amount of disk space left? Well, there was one option, buying a new PC. So I made an announcement in my videos to tell I had to take a break from either making videos or streams, because I wanted to buy the new PC. I needed it to work on my upcoming projects, and so my search for a new PC started. Around the end of May 2019, I've made the decision to finally take my break to focus on buying a new PC. The disk space problem was about to get worse and worse in every video I've made, and it was time for some action. I however needed money, a lot of money to finally make buying the new PC a reality. I however was able to get some money here and there. Whilst I had vacation, I had a part-time job somewhere close to our house. I didn't earn a lot, but every cent counted to get closer and closer to the ultimate upgrade. In the meantime, the results of the exams were also announced and I paid for it, meaning that I would get some extra money out of it. In the meantime, I still watched these so-called sprite animations, and I was curious if someone was able to reply to my comment. And one of these persons was called Smasherblock, aka Smasher. After watching his about page, it turned out he came from the same country as me, so I placed a comment to see if he would respond. And as it turned out, yes he did. And with that, I added him on Discord. Now back in the day I was like, this will be a random person that I will chat with sometimes. So I decided to just go back to what was more important. It was around July when I really took action and asked my parents if I could buy the PC a bit earlier than intended. They approved, but I had to buy it from the computer shop close to our house. They also suggested me to ask if my old PC was upgradable, so I asked that and it seemed like it was impossible. So my only option was to get a new PC. The budget I had was 1,000 euros. So the employee was searching for the PC I needed. Whilst he did that, Roy also told me I had to show him the PC first before buying it. Within a week, the employee found the first PC. It had a GeForce GTX 1050 graphics card, 12 GB of RAM, 1.2 2 terabytes of disk space, an HN i7 processor, and everything else in screenshot notes. Due to my insanity to finally see a PC that could potentially be mine shortly after, I asked the employee questions like, is it a brand new PC, how much guarantee does it have, how much does it cost, and much more. After all those questions, I decided to buy this PC that was 1135 euros. I was so happy that after 3 relentless yes, I finally bought a new PC. So I shared the news with my friends, and when Roy saw it, I knew I had made a horrible mistake. See, back in the day, I cared the most about RAM and disk space, but in order to play video games on it, you need a good graphics card. Now, a GTX 1050 was good, but it wasn't enough to run your game smoothly. You at least need a 1050 Ti or a 1060 for it. And also, what the hell was that price? 1100 euros for that? That is way too much for a PC with those amount of specs. With that said, I wanted to cancel the order and look for a different PC with better specs, but as it turned out, they did already order the PC and they were unable to cancel it. That was such a wrong move, but it didn't matter. It still was a huge upgrade. With my PC finally being arrived, it was time to get my programs back and move on with editing. After a countless amount of months with inactivity, it finally looked like there was an end on the tunnel. I continued with editing my upcoming project, the top 25 best custom tracks of the current CTGP version around that time. I also went back to live streaming, and I really have gotten proof that I needed a new PC. Streaming went a lot easier than I've ever imagined. I was finally able to stream in 720p 60fps and a whopping 4000 bits. That was an insane amount. I finally enjoyed streaming again, but once again, that project was standing in my way and it was time to move on with that. In the meantime, Ray introduced me to a new game, and that game was called Dead by Daylight. Gosh, this game was enjoyable. Of course, I had to learn the basics of the game, but I knew this was going to be a game I will play a lot in the future. Now moving on with the video, because I had something huge in mind for it. I finally wanted to speak English in the video. It was about time to see how good my English really was.
To start with this list, we got a very unique track. Glimmer Express trains let you drive in 2 trains that actually move.
Yeah, no, not that great, but at least I attempted it. With the video being done, it was time to begin my epic moment montage. I've been wanting to work on it for the longest time. I started working on this video right before my 18th birthday. Oh yeah, that's right, my birthday. So that day, I honestly expected a normal day with some visitors. However, that'll change when they gave me my birthday present. A Nintendo Switch with Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. My god, that somehow was the best birthday present I've ever gotten, and I was really, really happy with it. I could finally play a Mario Kart I wanted to play for over 5 years. With that being said, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe also was a game I could stream on YouTube, so I decided to stream the game at some point. The frame rate was kept at 30fps, but who cares? The screen was in HD and the overall quality of the Switch was a lot better than the Wii, but Mario Kart 8 Deluxe had more potential. Say, I was working on my Epic Moments video, why not adding some Mario Kart 8 Deluxe clips into it? That would work perfectly since it could have some variations. Only a few days after I've gotten my Switch, I've also decided to buy Super Mario Maker 2, since that also was a game I wanted to play for a long time. So I bought the game and I streamed it to YouTube. It was finally time to go back to streaming again and head to 1000 subscribers. Well... so, we're stuck with another problem. The PC was in the best state for around 2 weeks because a key broke from my PC. So I had to go to the computer shop to fix it. The first time when it happened wasn't a huge deal. I got it back really soon. That did change, however, when I sent it to the computer shop for the second time. They told me this was a serious problem and they had to send it to Lenovo, the company where I got the PC from. Not a big problem. They just fixed my keyboard and I got it back ASAP. Still haven't heard anything from the shop. What the hell happened out there? Was there a malfunction or did they straight up ignore phone calls to tell how the PC is doing? They've been doing that for 4 weeks and I've gotten tired of it. All I had was my old PC that ran out of disk space. All I could do was to just play on the Nintendo Switch and that's it. How much longer will it take? A phone call, an unknown number was calling me, but it turned out to be the computer shop. They said, "Hello Yook, your PC is fixed, you can pick it up tomorrow." What the f-
pineapple?
That came out of seemingly nowhere. We literally had no updates about my PC throughout the period of 4 weeks, and suddenly my PC is back? The next day, I decided to pick it up. It seemed like it was acting normally. Alright, it is finally time to move on with YouTube. Oh for f- sake, what is it now? Another problem? Ugh. I was on the verge to consider buying a new PC at this point. This was seriously unacceptable. I paid 1100 euros to get a PC that worked perfectly fine. Not a PC that gets fatal errors every 2 days. But whatever, I've made the decision to give it one more attempt. I brought it back to the computer shop and as it turned out, the SSD broke. So that was a problem that got solved within a day. What a relief. Going a few days back in time, I finally got a place to work and earn money. This was in progress for a long time, but on November 4, 2019, I finally got a contract to work at a supermarket in the Netherlands by the name of Albert Heijn. Yeah, I know it can mean a lot, but moving on with the story. After one tedious month of not having my PC with me, things finally went back to normal. Gosh, that period was painful. Whatever. Around the time I was absent, I threw a lot of my time away on the Epic Moments montage, meaning I was running behind on my schedule. I was so relieved that I had managed to save my progress on the video, otherwise I had to redo the first few minutes of the video. That doesn't sound like it's a lot, but from that point, every millisecond counted. Throughout this period, I was able to only make one livestream. One. But I had no choice. My video was at my top priority and I had to work on it as much as I possibly could. Luckily, I was able to consistently work on the video and from time to time I was able to get back on track. I was able to make some pretty fun moments here and there, even in such a short period. After a month of working 24/7 on the video, it was finally done. Man, that was such a journey. I was extremely tired after I've completed the video, and with that, I uploaded it to YouTube. I was so glad that I was done with this video, cause it was a huge upgrade over the old Epic Moments video from a year ago. I focused a lot more on editing, I've added some references from the old Epic Moments video, the music selection was better, and the overall pacing was an improvement over the old version. I was really happy with this video, and I still am to this day. But as time went on, we were getting closer and closer to 2020. But there was one more thing I wanted, just one more project before the year ends. I was too tired to make a top 20 or top 50 best moment, so I kept it simple. A year revealed that was only 10 minutes long. This was somewhat doable, so I focused on that. And to be honest, I did a decent job on it. I still told everything I could possibly tell. About that 2019 wasn't a great year for me on YouTube, but a great year for everything else. I have somehow learned to be more fair in my opinions. I tried to be fair to tell I didn't felt like to stream a lot this year. The fact I couldn't upload those projects a bit earlier because bigger problems were standing in my way, and a lot more. After uploading the video, we had to say goodbye to the 2010s, cause we were about to go to 2020. This was a year when things truly were starting to heat up on my channel, but let's start with how it began. Generally speaking, I knew 2020 would be an important year for me, since I was nearing 500 subscribers, a milestone I've dreamed of for a long time. So 2020 began like how 2019 began, but this time I only focused on live streaming. I just had to take a solid break from making videos. The only video I've made, however, was this new intro, and I think most of you recognize this one. I used it not that long ago, so I'm quite sure some of you still recognize this intro. My idea behind this intro was instead of making my intro Super Mario Bros. Like, Mario Kart like, since my channel was all about Mario Kart. So I found this intro pretty solid. Now onto streaming. Thus I typically went on with streaming Mario Kart, there also was a new game I wanted to stream. Same with me. Dead by Daylight. So I did a stream on this game and I had a blast. Roy also decided to join halfway through the stream and we had a fun time. Although I kinda sucked in the game back in 2020, but it didn't matter, as long as I had fun, it was all fine. DVD was such an unpopular topic on my channel. I almost had no viewers, but gosh, that stream was insanely fun to make. With it in mind to stream the game more in the future, I went back to stream Mario Kart Wii and Super Mario Maker 2. I had in mind to stream once per week and that worked out quite well. I had enough time to do things on my own, and following my stream schedule wasn't getting boring. After a few weeks, I returned with another DVD stream, and then I did something that nobody expected. It was February 2020, and it was that day I talked with Smasher. He asked me if I played on an emulator before. I sure did, I had an emulator on my Wii. He then asked me if he would like to participate with an upcoming Let's Play he had planned, cause he wanted to promote my channel. That was kinda sick, and I would love to participate with him. But there was one problem, a problem that ruined all of it. His channel was English, and my channel was Dutch. So that means that either my viewers will cringe at my hilariously bad English or Smash's promotion will fall, cause all his viewers expected English content on my channel. But hold it, the fact he even said his channel was English was so inspirational for me that literally the next day I wanted to do it. Do the thing people asked for over 3 years. If Smash had an English channel and asked me to train his Let's Play, why not make my own channel English as well? I decided to do it, making an update video entirely in English to tell my channel would finally be in English from that point. But not only that, I've also decided to unlist all my videos that were outdated. My god, I was so happy that I finally made this decision. My channel was now in English and I unlisted over 300 videos. I had to get used to this update, so it took me a while to stream again, but I decided to return shortly after. But before doing any of that, I first had in mind to also remake my channel trailer, but now in English and much better edits. Man, I needed that. This trailer was a lot better than my old trailer. It was shorter, much easier to understand, and I used more clips instead of just overlapping text in the video. Even though this intro is outdated, I gotta admit that I'm still satisfied with the upgrades I've made compared to the old version of my trailer, but with that, I really decided to get back into action. Thus, I had some videos in mind to improve my English, I decided to cancel all of them and just focus on live streaming. It already started on February 29. From that day, I had the schedule in mind. I'll be streaming 4 games in a period of 4 weeks. The order was Mario Kart Wii, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, Dead by Daylight and Super Mario Maker 2. I showed them a new channel art. That's right, I've also decided to make new channel art to really show my schedule of my live streams. Later improve my Nibiru. Anyways, going back to the first English live stream, and I really tried to speak English the best I could, but it just didn't work, which left some pretty cringe moments in this stream. Because of that, I decided to make the stream a bit shorter than normal. Let me show you a quick clip of my English there.
Is it finally time? Finally time to make an English livestream. Welcome back guys to Mario Kart Wii. Today I'm going to play worldwide. Yeah, my English is a bit bad. Sorry about that. But I'm trying my best. That's all I'm gonna say.
To be honest, every time I listen to this, it makes me cringe. But whatever. I tried to improve my English a bit by correctly pronouncing the words I had to say whilst I wasn't streaming. I still do that to this day, by the way. But with that, it slowly, and I really mean slowly, was starting to get better and better. But my English was still garbage even after a month. But I didn't care about that. I was like, the more I stream, the better it goes. After following the schedule for a few weeks, the game I had to play now was Super Mario Maker 2. For a strange reason, something hit me here. The stream went how I expected it, a decent amount of viewers, and I even gained a subscriber. Yeah, very funny I gained a subscriber. No, but really, subscribers were critical for me in that period. The more I gained, the closer we were to the ultimate milestone. 500 subscribers, so that was pretty sick. But something weird happened, specifically on that livestream. I somehow managed to gain 5 subscribers in a day. That was something unreal, and for some reason, my subscriber count kept going up for the next few days. So I was wondering, how did it happen? Did it have something to do with the Super Mario Maker 2 stream? I didn't know, but as time went on, I went back to Mario Kart Wii, and this stream with no doubt went a lot better than the previous Mario Kart Wii stream. I still had a lot of slip off the tongues, but I didn't care about that anymore. The more I did it, the more I learned of it. In the meantime, my subscriber count still went up, but I had in mind to still go on with my schedule. I however was curious if those subscribers really came from my Super Mario Maker 2 livestream I made a while ago. Then Mario Kart 8 stream happened, and this is where I tried to stream my Switch at 60fps. See, you had 30fps when you didn't record the game, but when you did, the frame rate will go up to 60. I don't know why, but I was thinking to give this a try. And it worked. The more I streamed, the more I got used to speak English. And then it was week 3. We're back at DBD. And this is where a massive slogan for my channel was born, the Game Yuk hat. This logo was beloved by many. But back to DBD, I realized I now had to play the game in low settings, cause my framerate was starting to get really, really bad. When I streamed whilst playing DBD, my framerate was between 25 and 40fps on the lowest settings available. I don't know why, but it somehow happened. Still though, the game wasn't unplayable, so I moved on with it. But oh boy, when the fourth week came along, this is where things really were starting to heat up. April 18, 2020, a day I made the Super Mario Maker 2 stream that was 8 hours long. You heard that right, 8 hours long. And before jumping into that, starting from this stream, I finally decided to for the first time make a stream layout. This included the window capture of the game, a background, the live chat and some information. I made it all myself, quite clean isn't it? Now onto the stream. Now this stream has a lot of backstory. Right before I started this stream, I wanted to stream for 4 hours of me playing your levels in Super Mario Maker 2. Thus I had that in mind, I also decided to work on my own level. At first I was kind of afraid nobody would join, and because of that my stream would end really soon because I had nothing to do. So after going on for a bit, it seemed like a certain someone actually cared to join my stream. He said in his level, so I played it. I again was afraid nobody cared about joining the stream, so it was just me and him. After doing that for a while, more people were starting to join in. Meh, still boring. Now we got two people in my stream. How was I ever supposed to reach 500 subscribers in this specific livestream? I was starting to wonder if it even was worth my time to go on. But then, around 2 hours in the stream, again more guys has joined. It started with a guy by Dane. He was also consistently sending in his levels in the queue. When he did that for a while, more and more people joined. At some point I already reached 7 concurrent viewers, the highest amount of concurrent viewers I had in a long time. And also, let's talk about the new subscribers. I gained a subscriber in the first 3 hours in the stream, which okay, you don't see a lot, but after hour 3 of the stream, my subscriber counter exploded. I gained a total of 5 subscribers over the next 30 minutes. That was huge. I just couldn't stop streaming anymore till some point late in the evening. Playing all of these levels was nothing short of insane, and I had something big in mind. I wanted to continue streaming the next day to go on with the countdown to 500 subscribers. I immediately moved on with streaming after waking up the next day. Though it wasn't as busy anymore, I still managed to get some subscribers out of it, and now I was above 490 subscribers. But due to being so close to my ultimate milestone, I found it extremely fun to stream this game and meet new people. I met people like Dane DiBella, Special Do, UltraLex, GMS Nico, and much more. Nothing was standing in my way. Streaming was my key to achieve my dream. After a few more streams, it seemed like it was the end of the line. My subscriber count was at 499 and I needed one more subscriber.
Alright, there we go. Nothing too special. Alright, got some coins. Wow! Somebody subscribed. Thank you. We got 500 again.
And there you have it. The journey of daily live streaming was over. I've achieved my milestone and it's done. Well, that's what I thought. But that wasn't what I thought. I uploaded this after I've reached my 500 subscriber milestone. And looking at the title, you knew things would be good. Let's hear it.
I got some really good news for those who really like 2017 on my channel. You remember this? Or this? Or this? Let's talk about it. Because I've reached the 500 subscriber milestone and also gained like a lot of subscribers in the past couple of days, I finally got a motivation to bring them back. I already started this Saturday and I will continue to do it for, I guess, the next 3 or 4 months. And also I guess this will be the easiest way to grow my channel to 1000 subscribers. That will be really cool.
That's right, the SMM2 streams became so inspiring that I just had to continue. I had a new goal in mind. It's going to be tough, but I knew I could do it. Stream daily till I have 1000 subscribers. I still was afraid I couldn't do it because I had many failed attempts before. The MK7 streams, the 30th fight scenes, and even the projects. So there was only one option left. Return the daily live streams and do not retire before I have 1k subs. That will work out. Meanwhile, Nibiru saw potential in updating my stream layout, so he did that. This layout was a lot cleaner than a layout I've used before because it was using outlines. It makes the layout much more understandable, so I went with this layout instead. After streaming SMM2 for a while, it seemed to perfectly work out. I've met new people, my subscriber count went up really fast, and I still enjoyed doing it for you guys. If you just didn't mind my awful English, it worked out perfectly fine. But if you did, it either can be horrible or hilarious. Here's one of my older clips.
3 viewers, wow. I don't know. I have a... Oh. Can you search it up? No, super beauty. 3 viewers, wow. It's like super beauty, but no. At the same time, just no.
I am so glad Ray gave that to me, otherwise this clip was nowhere to be found again. Whilst making these streams, I also decided to upload a bunch of videos. Now what's interesting was that these videos got watched a lot more than the videos that were published before the daily streams. Some of them got like 30 views within an hour, and that is quite a lot compared to my videos that were published before the daily streams. Back in the day when I published a video, I only managed to get like 5 viewers within an hour and not much higher. So that was kinda hilarious if I say so myself. I mostly focused on challenges. One of the most popular ones was, if I do this, the video ends. I did that on Super Mario Maker 2 and even Dead by Daylight. I also made a compilation of all my intros used so far on my channel, or me playing Super Expert in Super Mario Maker 2. That video turned out to be a nightmare, I gotta admit. Anyways, the more streamed, the busier these streams have gotten. From 10 concurrent viewers, to 12, to 15, to eventually close to 20. And I still get like 5 subscribers a day, getting me to 600 subscribers. At this point, I was certain, the 1000 subscribers milestone will be there at some point. And with that being said, I also wanted to work with Q, since that also was something that got heavily requested by viewers. At first, I opened a Word document on Google Drive and some guys I trusted were able to submit levels from the viewers. That was way easier than searching the levels up in the live chat after each level you've completed. Nothing was able to stop me from streaming. At some point in May, I decided to, instead of streaming on OBS, stream on Streamlabs, because somebody told me I had access to way more sources. Sources like loyalty items, setting up a subscriber goal, able to set up donations via PayPal, and much more. That was ideal for me, so I moved on with Streamlabs. After some streams, I just had to take a break from Super Mario Maker 2 to stream the first ever Mario game I've ever gotten, Mario Kart Wii. I just wanted to stream this game for once, because every time I play this game, it just brings back so many memories. And also, Mario Kart Wii, with no doubt, is my favorite Mario game of all time. It was worth my time to go back to this for once. After that, I moved on with Super Mario Maker 2. Whilst doing that, there was this one stream where I met a guy by the name of The Real DGR Gaming. And I think you're wondering, why am I mentioning him and not any of you? Well, that's going to be important for later. May was about to end, and if you're a daily stream veteran on my channel, I think you know where the next topic is going to. Right, that one moment where one of my family members passed away. To not go all out on this topic, I'm not going to tell anything about it. I'm just going to focus on the video and how it went with me. But anyways, as you can tell, that was a pretty emotional moment for me, and I even said that in this video. But the amount of comments I've gotten of saying, get well soon, was beyond insane. Over 30 plus comments, and I really appreciated that. But it didn't matter. Life went on, and I just needed to take a break for a week. When the week ended, I was all back and things were back to normal. After your typical doses of daily live streaming, I've decided that after a while, I also wanted to stream more games, like Mario Kart Wii, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, and even Dead by Daylight. I really wanted to take it a bit more quiet with my schedule at this point, because I've learned in my break that my daily live streaming, it can be a bit too intense sometimes. I still did stream like 4 times a week, but damn, daily live streaming was really starting to get on my nerves, especially with workarounds. All these streams are typically the same, just me playing your levels like the normal days. I still couldn't believe how daily live streaming changed my whole channel. I was still heading to the ultimate goal. Whilst doing that, it was about time for The Real DGR Gaming to introduce me to someone. DGR and I were chatting on Discord with each other, and he introduced me to another streamer that also actively streams Super Mario Maker 2. His name was Failer Gamer. Back in the day, I had no idea who he was, but DGR wanted me to do a collaboration stream with him, because both Failer and I were about to reach a big subscriber milestone. The 500 subscribers milestone for Failer, and the 750 subscriber milestone for me. After chatting with Failer for a while and joining his server, I knew this collaboration would happen, so I planned it for later. However, starting from this point, my AV Media capture card was starting to run into an issue. Huge lag spikes. I decided to live with it, but the more I went on, the worse it has gotten. But I will get into that later. Before moving on, I made an announcement ping on my Discord server that I will stop the daily livestreams because it was getting too much for me. I, however, was in a really bad mood that day, so no wonder why I left a message like that. I, however, made a video shortly after to say the message was not real and I will continue the daily stream so I have 1k subs. Also, in this video, I kind of talked about a huge collaboration video that will come out at the end of the year. I will continue to explain more about this later in the video. Back to streaming. As soon as I stream Super Mario Maker 2 again, I've gotten my first raid. It was for Failer Gamer, and again, I've met new people. The most recognizable one was Mario the Maker, now known as the Revolution Cafe, and also, Failer was nice enough to also donate some money, $3 in total. It's cool to see how nice people can be sometimes. After some time, the collab stream happened, and both Failer and I had a blast to complete Wu Wu Finish level first, so I announced this will happen more often in the future. But when? A few days later, I had to take a break because I was going on a vacation for a week. I had a very fun time. We have done a lot of things out there, go swimming, dining out, we went to the city, and much more. I kinda missed streaming whilst I was on vacation, but as soon as I was back, I went all out to streaming again. I was back with the daily live streams, and starting from that point, I also focused on streaming multiplayer versus in Super Mario Maker 2. Well, I was not able to do that with all the levels since there were some levels that were either really bad or just too easy. It was also at this point where I've reached the 800 subscribers milestone, 200 more to go. I still wasn't burnt out or tired from streaming, but the closer we were to 1000, the more impatient I've gotten. But it didn't matter. We were at the halfway point. All I had to do was to stream. to stream a lot, and with that said, Fela came to me to say there was a way to fix the delay. I lowered it multiple times before. I remembered having a minute delay on my stream. I lowered it before to make the delay only 30 seconds, but that still wasn't enough by any means, so why not lower the delay to only 5 seconds? After doing some setups, Fela and I managed to lower the delay to only 5 seconds, and man, I didn't thought communicating would be that much easier than with a 30 second delay, but I guess that was the case. Around this time, I also managed to learn something. Yeah, sure, improving my English, but also something else. And if I say the word moderator, I think most of you know where this is going to. I won't say any names, but there was a certain person on my Discord server that shared all that luck with others. These were private, extremely private. He has been a mod for a few months, but Roy decided that he was done with his actions, so he went to me to ask to remove his mod. With some discussions, we've made the decision to remove his mod from either YouTube and Discord. So the thing is, back in the day, I basically didn't care who was mod and who wasn't. I gave everybody who asked moderation mod on my channel. I especially did that in 2017, which is the reason why I have so many mods on my channel. I did it much less in 2020, but I still didn't learn from the mistake when I started these daily streams back in April. I'm really thankful that I actually learned that later on in July, otherwise my channel would be in trouble nowadays. Now on with the queue, since I've been using the Word document for the longest time, my viewers suggested me to now use Beanstalk instead. This website had an automatic queue which was way easier for the viewers to follow. Unfortunately, right at the moment I used it, the website got taken down by the creators of the website. Great, how am I able to make queues now? We'll get to an answer later, cause I had a bigger problem to get rid of first. Of course, the capture card. I said before that my strings are starting to lag really badly, so I made the decision to get into action. After I told my parents that my old capture card was starting to get really old, they allowed me to buy a new one. So I went with an Elgato HD60S Plus. This one was far more expensive than the AVMedia capture card I bought 3 years ago. This one cost 200 euros. When it arrived, I decided to test it out. But no matter what program I used, nothing seemed to work out. After a while of trying things out, I decided to stream it so others could help. And for a strange reason, even those who got an Elgato capture card themselves weren't able to fix the problem. What was causing it then? After trying it out a few more times after the stream, we found the problem, and it was shocking I didn't solve it before. Great, I've bought a capture card that doesn't support a Nintendo Switch. I am such an idiot. After telling it to my parents with some discussions, I was able to refund my capture card and buy a new one that was able to capture your Switch. After a long break, I finally returned, but it wasn't a fun time. Heck, I despise being away from the platform. I was so close to give up hope because I was at 900 subscribers now. Only 100 to go. I really had to focus on streaming daily at this point because I was about to achieve it. There was no turning back now, but there was a specific thing that held me back. The hot weather. I seriously had to skip some streams because it was too hot. But there was more. Since I had a new capture card, things were a hell of a lot different. I couldn't stream on the custom frame rate anymore, the lag was somehow even worse than it needed to be, and the overall experience was miserable at the first streams. And I had to do something with the specs. After thinking on what to do, I have realized that Elgato has a built-in streaming software, so I decided to use that for a temporary time. It worked, but it got rid of my stream layout, which was one of the most important things for me to have at that time. But I managed to fix some stuff here and there. After following my schedule for a bit, I've heard of a hype for a game, Fall Guys Ultimate Knockout. I bought the game somewhere mid-August and I streamed it shortly after. However, due to my not so great specs and horrible internet, it lagged like crazy. Most of the time, I only ran between 20 to 40 FPS. That was straight up miserable for a game I used to run at 60 FPS, even with the highest specs available. But it didn't matter. I was not giving up and continued with it. But that, however, went way worse than I thought. After some daily streams, we were already nearing September, and my subscriber count was nearing 950 subscribers, so I was starting to doubt, was reaching 1k subs before my 19th birthday possible? August went by and now it was September. I was making things ready for the 1k special. I made a trailer somewhere at the end of August, I was starting to work on the video, but due to some things I wanted to have back, I decided to cancel some streams. I really wanted to stream on Streamlabs again, but due to lag, that wasn't possible. However, keeping my frame rate at 30fps went a lot better, and with that, I finally got my layout back. Damn, what a relief. To add some extra spice to the Ultimate Countdown, I've decided to sometimes stream twice a day. However, because of work, it honestly didn't go that well. It didn't matter. As long as I streamed at least once per day, I could keep it with my schedule. But there again were things standing in my way, and the most noticeable one was my hay fever. But it didn't matter. I decided to stream anyways. The milestone was far more important than cancelling a stream because you're not feeling well. I however sneezed a lot, and thanks to the Revolution Cafe, a new legendary meme was born.
Can you guys tell me when the stream is lagging? Oh god. Pineapple! This is really working?
Yeah, that wasn't the original sound effect. I think you meant this one.
Pineapple.
Much better. The next day went a lot smoother. My hay fever was not fully restored yet, but it went a lot better. And when that stream was done, my subscriber count was hanging at 986. 14 more to go. Could the next day be the one? Then it was Saturday, so this day went quite horrible at start. I streamed twice, but I again struggled with lag. No matter how much I tried to restart my stream, the lag didn't go away. But I decided to save my second stream for later in the day. But instead, I'll stream OBS. The second stream seemed to work a lot better than the first stream. Thank god actually, cause this was the stream where I expected it to happen. The stream where I would reach 1000 subscribers. I was only 30 subscribers away from my milestone. So I asked myself, was it really possible? The stream started differently than any other stream. I played some music in the background only to show my subscriber counter to slowly go up. In the meanwhile, I decided to VCM my server for the first time. There were some people in it actually, like the Revolution Cafe, Akira, later followed by Brainstorm and some others. Whilst we were talking, someone decided to boot up Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, so me and all the others in the VC decided to join. However, I didn't want to show my screen until a bit later. But because I wanted to show the sub counter to show 1000 on the big screen, I decided to just do this. People didn't like that. How about this then? Still not good enough? Fine. I will just show my melee out. Not a lot happened in the first hour, but I was about to change. After a while, the first subscriber was in. 12 more to go. Still though, was I really able to get this milestone that day? Not really. 30 minutes after I've gotten my first subscriber, the counter was still standing at 988. Now I was starting to get really afraid I couldn't reach the big milestone anymore. So here was my next decision. If doing a VC was this fun, why not making a second and a third party next days? That probably was a good reason to get the milestone right at my birthday. It was the perfect plan. 20 minutes later, I decided to... Wait a minute, why is my subscriber counter at 990 suddenly? Wait, was it going to happen that day? After 2 hours of thinking it wasn't possible, I again was starting to doubt myself. And from that point, the hype was really starting to go insane. The longer I went on, the more concrete viewers I've gotten to count down with me. The chat was massively sharing the news on social media to gain more and more viewers and of course subscribers. Just a few minutes later, my subscriber counter was at 992, then at 994, 995, and starting from that number, I was almost certain that this was going to happen today. And because of that, I had to say something.
Already saying to all of you, thank you so much for all your support throughout the years. Seriously, it means a lot to you. It means a lot to me. Oh my god! And my subscribers has doubled since the start of my daily streams. When I started, I got 480, and now I got 995.
If you know me for a long time, you know I'm always trying to go out of my way to make jokes on my stream. This message, however, was dead serious. I seriously was so thankful for everything that happened throughout these 4 months, I just couldn't leave it behind. But with that said, 5 more subscribers to go. Quickly after that, I gained another 3 subscribers, leaving the subscriber counter only 2 subscribers away from 1000. It was almost there. My long journey would finally be over. And then it was time. 999 subscribers. Only 1 subscriber away from 1000. Is it going to happen? Or not?
It's actually going to happen. 998. All right.
The only thing I'm scared about is I hope they're not sub bots, really.
Yeah, but I've made it a little bigger. Oh crap! No, okay. It is back to 997 now.
Oh really?
Yeah, indeed. But it doesn't matter. Okay, 996 now.
I have officially jinxed myself, we were back at 996, but like I said, I was relieved it didn't go back to like 991. After a few seconds, the counter was back at 997, and the countdown continued. Was it going to happen or not?
I mean, Google is way too secure with that stuff.
Okay, we need one more. Yeah.
We were back at 999. This moment was key for me. Now once again, was 1k going to happen or not?
Like, why shouldn't we? Ah, man.
Nope. But this time it only went back to 998, so the grind was still on. But I had the feeling someone told in the stream. For how long will it go on? We went to the next race, GC and Baby Park, and then out of seemingly nowhere, this happened.
We don't have any rules.
Winner gamer, I guess that's Failer, right?
Bangalore raid?
Wait, Failer, do you mean Discord with VC or what do you mean?
Wait, what?
That's VC, I don't know what you mean.
Bangalore raid?
I'm an idiot.
Okay. Yes, and we have 1,000 guys. We have 1,000. This is it.
How? I got raided by Bangalore? You know, the YouTuber with over 150k subscribers? Where in the hell did this came from? I was beyond surprised when I saw that gigantic amount of viewers joining my stream just to say I got hosted by this dude. I have never ever seen that before. But gosh, I have reached it. I have finally reached it. 1,000 subscribers. Gosh, I was so happy and thankful for the stuff that happened in this stream. It will be a stream I will never forget anymore. Ever. But due to the huge amount of views I've gotten, I decided to go on with MKA for a while. But there was something even bigger for me in store, my monetization request. While I was busy with some other things, I suddenly got surprised by a huge coincidence. September 14, 2020. It was my 19th birthday and I was working in the supermarket. After being done with my job for the day, I was looking on my phone for a second. And honestly, I couldn't believe my eyes from what I just saw. I just got approval to monetize my videos right at my birthday. Was this a dream or was this an actual reality? How in the hell was this possible? It wasn't even an achievement anymore. It was a birthday present. And it somehow managed to be an even better birthday present than getting a Nintendo Switch. When I got home, I immediately monetized my videos. In the meantime, I also announced that I will start on Twitch. I've been wanting to do that for a long time. I wanted to use Twitch to stream non-family friendly games like DBD. I however wasn't done with streaming yet. I still wanted to stream a lot. I got introduced to Super Chat, and to be honest, I didn't expect how many people used it. Certainly a lot more than PayPal donations. And this, my guys, is where my boy Stack joins the stream for the first time. Already from day one on the channel, he was really supportive and donated quite a lot of money to someone with only 1k subscribers. A few days later, I got introduced to my brand new community tab on YouTube. Back in the day, you needed 1k subscribers in order to have access to this tab. And to be honest, I spent a lot of my time to update you guys about future videos. It was a blessing using this thing. And to this day, I still use this tab almost daily, so it never gets old. Then the membership tab. This one arrived a few days later on my channel, but hearing from my reaction on my livestream, you know I was really happy when I saw it.
Which Wolverine? No! Oh my god! Holy s***! Sorry, that was a curse word. Oh my god, I'm actually so sorry I just said that. Holy s***! I said it again. Oh my god. I actually feel so sorry for you guys. Membership got enabled.
That was unexpected, but whoa, that was a nice surprise. Fast forwarding a bit later this year, I also made a series called Level Time Lapses of Super Mario Maker 2. This basically was a series where I made levels and viewers help me with it. This was quite cool to do, and I had a fun time. This also is something I want to bring back next year. And of course, let's not forget the stream marathon I had planned for October. This was originally meant to conclude the daily livestreams, but I've decided to not do that. This basically was a sequel to that old 5-hour stream for 2017, but instead I made that longer. This time I streamed Mario Kart Wii, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, Super Mario Maker 2, Fall Guys, and Among Us. I was really satisfied with how the stream went. The only problem I had was the Fall Guys stream. Luckily, Roy asked me if he could stream for me instead, cause the quality was that bad. So I gave him my stream key cause I knew I could trust him. The Among Us stream left some critics here and there cause people thought they could participate with it. I however had planned to host a private lobby instead to play the games with some friends. I understood why some of you were upset about that. Whatever, with no new things upcoming, I really had to start with the big compilation I mentioned before. However, I've gotten many suggestions throughout the daily streams that will make the video even bigger. I introduce you to Gaming Huge 4-in-1 special. So instead of only a compilation, I've gotten many suggestions from viewers to make make this video even bigger, mainly for Ultra OX. He came up with 3 out of the 4 chapters that were included in this video. Reading your favorite quotes, reaction to the blindfolded levels I've played in this period, and the theme song. That made an already big video even bigger. But you know, it's a Monkey special, so why not? Now, before getting into the video itself, let me tell you the backstory of this video. I've said multiple times before I wanted to make a timeless video on this huge video, but that just didn't happen. Then I'll just do it here, for just a little bit. And to get into that, we need to go back to May 2020. It began with this comment that said, you should make monthly compilations for your daily livestreams and compile the best moments for your compilation. Now, that was an amazing idea, but make a compilation once per month? I'm sorry, but I'm passing for that. I understand that people with a lot of subscribers do things like that, but I was a YouTuber with only 600-700 subscribers around that time, so that was a clear no. However, that comment gave me huge inspiration to make this video instead. But back in the day, I wanted to make all these clips myself. I already changed that in June 2020 by saying that instead of making the clips myself, you guys make them. That's at least the way to make the video all the more exciting. Now on to the beginning of the video, like the intro. Back in the day, this video was meant to have my really old intro. I mean this one. That is some old footage I'm seeing there, but the same counted for this intro. I think most of you are still familiar with this intro heavily reworked. However, you might want to see how the old versions were looking like, and here is the first version. Really old. This basically was just a beta. My idea back in the day was to take the same colors from the trailer and just add the text like that. I then, however, had an idea to improve it by a bit, and here's the second version. It was around this time the thumbnail was made, and I had a lot more potential to improve my intro by a bit. It however took me another month to make the final version of this intro, and that's where it stands today. And the font titles, I almost forgot about those. Now back in the day, I made them myself, and once again, I tried to match the colors from the trailer. White, yellow, blue, and red. These titles were meant to just play the starting leg music for Mario 64, even for the secret chapter and the credits. I also left out the voice clips like Chapter 1, the compilation, that was all added in later. When I post this to YouTube, people seem to be satisfied with it. I however had to change some things here and there. Once I did that, the bureau also saw the post and decided to remake the titles. When he sent it to me, I was stunned how amazing the font titles really were, so I decided to from that point use those. And from that point, I've decided to add the voice clips into it to make the font titles even better. One final thing to mention was that this video was originally meant to only have the compilation in it, but due to suggestions, this video has gotten bigger and bigger. And then of course the secret chapter. I had this in mind right after I started working on the second chapter. This chapter will be all about the milestones I've achieved during the career. And like I said before in my community post, this chapter foreshadowed this video. So secretly, there were a lot of mysteries in this video. Now, that was a lot of backstory, but I have managed to make a lot of progress. While the compilation was not even close to completion, I decided to already start with chapter 2, 3, 4 and the secret chapter. Making all of those chapters took me a long time to make, especially chapter 2, the reading quotes chapter. Now, there were a lot of quotes I had to read, about 75 to 100 quotes and also edit. This took me a whopping 12 days to make, so I almost spent 2 weeks on this chapter. The other chapters were a bit easier. Like the third chapter was to just record my reaction and add some edits here and there. I completed this chapter in like 2 days. Now, there's an interesting story behind chapter 4. So the lyrics were originally written by UltraLX, but Failer and I decided to improve them by a bit. In the meantime, I asked Failer to do the theme song, cause like I said before, I'm better singing and rapping. So he decided to do that, but only if he had time. But after days upon weeks, I didn't have a response yet. Seems like Failer was really busy with his own work, which was quite understandable. So I decided to take on the challenge and rap it myself. This had somehow worse than I thought, but hey, it worked. But let's be honest, this whole song was just one huge meme. Now on to the secret chapter. My favorite chapter I worked on and also my favorite chapter in the video. There was nothing too special on this video, but it was an absolute nightmare to look for these clips on my channel. But I managed to find them anyways. Other than that, this chapter was a blessed to work on. After all of that was done, it was time to re-render my intros. For my own intro, I decided to do something with my logo, which actually turned out to be pretty good. The other intro where however, was a hella different story. Instead of adding a background and some text, I decided to put some small clips of all the chapters in the video, without the secret chapter of course, but this turned out to be a lot better, and I was very satisfied with how it looked. With that completed, it was time to work on the credit segment, render the video to upload it to YouTube a few days later to premiere it. And that, my friends, is the end of the story, but not the end of the video. We have to go back to the title screen to play a new mode. Let's get there! ...2022, we're about to go to this year, but you might wonder, what is in store for this year on my channel? I'm going to name a few things I've planned to make and bring back this year, however, it is subject to change later on, so keep that in mind. First, let's talk about the livestreams. I want to head back to the schedule I've used in 2021, stream 2-4 times in a week, of course of all the main games on my schedule, like Mario Kart Wii, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, Super Mario Maker 2, Fall Guys, and maybe VR on YouTube. And of course, Dead by Daylight and Phasmophobia on Twitch. However, as I mentioned before in the second chapter of the video, I indeed also want to bring back the Mario Kart 7 livestreams. However, I need to re-download some stuff on my 3DS again in order to stream this game again, so don't expect a Mario Kart 7 livestream anywhere soon. And last but not least, I also will be continuing with some side games like Gothic Phone, Stick RPG 2, and maybe even Among Us. Again, I can't tell you when, but I will be trying to stream it as soon as generally possible. For Noble videos on the other hand, I'll be trying out some new things and also bring back some old stuff. As for the old stuff, we're still in the 5 years of Gamer U period, so I expect some more reboots from the past, like how do I edit my videos and my top 10 worst videos. These videos have a lot of potential to be re-uploaded in English, but once again, I can guarantee you this will really happen. For new videos, however, I want to try out tier list videos. I'm not entirely sure on what game I should make a tier list on, but Mario Kart Wii has a high priority. You will hear more about this in the future. The last thing to mention about videos is that you should not expect a big video like this one anytime soon. So to keep it simple, I don't mind to make a new Mario Kart compilation that will be a sequel to the Epic Moments Montage Ultimate Edition. You can expect this video to be released somewhere at the end of 2022. But before any of this, allow me to first take a solid break from making content on my channel. I don't know when I'm going to continue with making projects, but I hope I can continue with it anytime soon. I also have to take a break from making live streams. After working 6 hours on this video for 2 months straight, I really could use some rest. And with that being said, this is everything I got for 2022, so let's move on. Hey, look at that! We're back in 2021. It is time for another story. No, that wasn't the idea. Anyways, I'm going to do a short review of this year, and I will be including quite a lot of things. So 2021 was at its least a pretty interesting year for me. Now sure, I kind of watered down on YouTube compared to previous year, cause I streamed much less and we didn't have a countdown to 1k subs anymore. But even for this year, I still managed to achieve some important things. I've met some new friends, I've reached the 1.5k subscribers milestone on YouTube, my English improved, and a lot more. An achievement I'm really proud of this year is my editing skills. Now sure, I'm not a professional editor by any means since I still haven't learned all the tools on Premiere Pro yet, but I've managed to learn some new effects, and the most noticeable one are the typewriter effect and let's not forget the vignette tool. I just learned this tool and I used it quite a lot throughout this video. I'm using this at some more exciting and dark moments. This was a tool I wanted to learn for a long time, and the same goes with the typewriter tool, so I'm really thankful I learned it now. I've also managed to stream a lot this year like I said before, and with that said, I also started on Twitch, where of course I will stream the non-family friendly games on. I am really happy I finally started with it. I finally have some variations in my schedule again. But with no doubt, the biggest thing I've achieved this year is my setup. Now, I had this in mind for the past few years, but because my bedroom was so small back in the day, there was absolutely no way to make a gaming room out of it. Thank God I moved to another room actually. It was worth it. This feat wasn't possible with the help of you guys. Thanks to my donators, I was able to buy a new PC with an RTX 3070 graphics card and get a massive upgrade over the laptop with the GTX 1050 I had before. I also was able to buy a gaming desk, a gaming chair, a microphone, a VR headset, and a lot more. I am really thankful for this upgrade, because I was so done with sitting on my bed. There also were some moments in 2021 I didn't really like. Of course, wearing a mouth cap on my work because of the
pineapple
virus, the fact I threw cola on my PC and it broke afterwards, thank God I was able to buy a new PC shortly after. And to be honest, 2021 went by way too fast. But you know, every year goes by way too fast nowadays, so I don't really think this is a problem anymore. But with that being said, 2021 still was a year where I've discovered many new things, and it honestly was a blast. And with that being said, let's move on. Now we are at this topic, and I want to do a short recap of this video, like in how extremely tired I am right now after working non-stop on this video for the past 2 months, and some things I've forgotten or even said wrong. Now as you can tell, even though this video was a massive upgrade over the old channel history, I still have forgotten to add some things in the video. But to be honest, reviewing 5 years on my channel was nothing short of atrocious. So if I've forgotten something you have missed, I really do want to apologize for that. My main idea of this video was to include a lot of my videos and only explain a lot of backstory on the bigger and more important videos on my channel, like my projects or even some of my live streams. Thus doing that, I also had in mind to sometimes explain some things that happened in the outside world, like the fact my parents broke up, the passing away from one of my family members, and how I've upgraded my content. And to be honest, looking back to this video, I really had a lot to explain. I started making YouTube videos when I was 40 years old, and now I'm 20 years old, and to be honest, I'm blown away in how much I've grown on making YouTube videos. From year to year, I was slowly starting to try new things, from recording a Flash game on my PC to making fully edited videos on a professional video editor. And once again, you guys have helped me a ton with that. And I once again want to thank every single one who is watching this video currently, every single subscriber, every single friend, every person that helped me improve my content, and every single viewer that has watched my videos over the past 5 years. Whether if you liked or disliked my videos, I really do appreciate your support towards me and all my social media accounts. But with that said, I really hope this story will inspire you to start your YouTube journey as well. And very enough when making a video, everyone needs to learn from their mistakes, including myself. I cringe at my old videos, but I'm generally relieved I made small updates throughout time. If you just believe in yourselves, you will eventually get to a level you want to be. And with that said, enjoy this 2021 compilation made by Nibiru. Have a great 2022, and we all speak each other soon again. Thanks for watching.
What do you want me to say?
Volknalknaller.
Volknalknaller.
Say it again.
Fala canacanane.
What is happening here? What is happening here? Oh, come on. Somebody bent into me.
Omae wa mou shindeiru. Nani?
What is that? Pretty childhood now.
Yeah, boy.
Okay, then.
I don't even see you as a mod. You're like a really. What in the flying?
Make it to the window, please. Make it. Nope. Dude. I think Enzo is going to win because he's really catching up to me right now. He is really. No. Well, I guess not. Yeah, we'll get second place. What the hell? Okay, what the hell was that? What the hell was that? Open up your line and arms, watch out, here I come. Spin me right round, baby, right round. Like a record, baby, right round, round, round. Also nice voice crack. Did you hear my voice crack? Oh my, whoa. How did he finish? Excuse me? Okay. How dare you? Seriously. Okay, that's unfair. That is unfair.
Oh, wait a second. I didn't do that. I honestly didn't do that.
No. Can't touch me. Oh, wow, he DC'd. He did a DC. Never mind them. Oh, no. Look at this dude. Oh. Okay. Take that.
Hello there.
This is the strangest Bubba I have seen in a long time.